Yeah, I mean, I thought mobile phones would be a lot farther along, but that's you know, you guys were talking about the iPhone, and
I think they're slow
and all that.
I think my sleek iPhone.
Sure,
I think the phone companies are slowing down the progress. I mean, it's obvious that. Yeah, you see what's going on in other countries with the cell phone, and we could easily be doing the exact same thing. But there's so much power with these phone companies in the United States. They want to just give you a little piece at a time, so you keep updating your phones.
Europe and Asia basically set the standards and says, you know, this is the way things are going to be. And in the United States, they kind of let the mobile phone companies just run amok. Mm. I'm really happy the iPhone came out. It's got a lot of issues, but it's headed in the right direction, where phones should be just handheld personal computers, and you can go wherever you want on the web, do whatever you want. I mean, Verizon's getting in trouble right now because, you know, they've been, and this has happened in the past, they cripple phones. Like, they'll buy phones from BlackBerry or from Nokia or whomever, and they'll take functions out. Like, they'll disable the GPS function in this new BlackBerry 8830 so that they can have their own GPS function that they charge you $10 a month for.
Holy shit.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, there's a lot of people that are pissed off about
that.
There's
your Verizon.
Hey, look, you know what? Charge me $10 a month. I don't drop my calls. I like that snarky, jizzy nerd with the fucking... Can you hear me now? You bet I can, sweet potato. You bet I can hear you now. On the iPhone, boy, does it look lovely. Hello. Oh, by the way, you guys are talking, I apologize, but the iPhone, I'm glad it came out to Laszlo. AT&T, great fucking company. If you happen to live on the fucking roof of the AT&T building, you can hear everything. Just fantastic. Let's see. I want you to just, I don't want, oh no, where is it?
Hey, can I make a suggestion, Jimmy? Anthony made a video where he was destroying
Windows, my Vista.
Vista.
That had millions of hits.
Millions of hits. I think it's time for you to make a video trashing your iPhone. It'll be the hit. It'll be the hit of the net.
Do you know I got recognized for that video? Not as Anthony from the Opie and Anthony show. Some guy said, I know you. And I was like, yeah.
In the inner tubes.
I do radio. And he goes, no. And I'm like, yeah. He goes, you did the Vista thing on the web. You shredded your Vista. It's like, yeah, but I'm a fucking radio star, you cocksucker.
It is funny when you recognize for something completely different than
funny.
The radio show.
I was on the west side of Manhattan yesterday. I was on 66th, and this is my girlfriend's. This is between 11:03 and 11:07.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to see, what's that say under her name?
10 calls?
No, you're reading it wrong.
Oh, sorry. 16 calls?
16 fucking dropped calls.
Are you kidding
16
me?
16 failed on the west side of Manhattan. This is not like I was in some, like, you know, the outbacks of Pennsylvania somewhere where you have like a little mountain range or the Adirondacks in New York. I was on the west side of Manhattan, 66th Street, between, like driving around.
There. Mountains over there, though. Yes, 66th.
Yes, the Martin Luther King School on 66th. I couldn't get over it. 16 fucking calls.
I have not had a call fail yet.
Yeah, there's a weird thing going on here, Laszlo. Anthony loves his iPhone. Can't get enough of it. It's ridiculous.
He gave me the whole tutorial the other day.
Yeah. He could be a spokesperson for this iPhone at this point. And Jimmy is completely on the other side. Hates it. He's days away from smashing this thing.
What I hate is AT&T. They're a terrible carrier. And the bottom line is, look, I Apple is great. I mean, I like to love my Mac, but what they do is they make themselves so hard to deal with that nobody wants to fight. They couldn't get a European carrier for a long time because they want so much shit. They're so arrogant to deal with them. It's hard to deal with them.
Yeah.
Verizon has been rated by Consumer Reports as the best mobile phone network.
By far.
Yeah.
And it's unfortunate that, you know, going back to the mobile phone companies, it's unfortunate that you can't just go buy an iPhone and pick your fucking carrier.
Exactly. Yeah, no kidding. That's what I was saying. Now, that's it. The phone company shouldn't hold you hostage to what phones you should buy. If you want to get the best phone, you should be able to pick whatever company you want.
You know, and signing exclusivity deals to one specific carrier and these fucking two-year contracts where I have to pay you $175 if I want to switch providers.
In 2 years, the phones, technology in phones change over 2 years where, you know, if you want to change phones, you're fucked. You gotta wait. I had to pay a fee to change over to the iPhone. because I didn't want to sit there. He's showing me the skateboarding dog again. Yeah. See, it's just magnificent.
It's really cool. What, did that take you 3 weeks to download?
You just aren't in a Wi-Fi area.
Yeah, I know. I don't Dan live on AT&T his... Boulevard in fucking... what city is that? Atent. How do you say it? Atent.
Dan, a huge fan of the iPhone as well. It should be pointed
out. The iPhone is a fucking work of art. The problem is the way they fucking went with AT&T. It's not the phone that's the problem. It is AT&T. And I've had a guy at the Apple store tell me, we're getting nothing but complaints about AT&T.
Wow. They
fucking knocked their stock down because people couldn't sign up right.
Yeah.
Come on, man. It's embarrassing.
I find myself sitting in front of the computer. Like last night, I was playing a little online poker, and then I have my iPhone in my hand, and I'm doing stuff that I'd normally do on my computer. You know, cruising the web, checking emails, things
missing
like
calls.
That. Missing calls.
Can't call failed. Error sending text message. You see that little green thing? The way when you send a text message, you go bing. And of course, apparently, there's a transcriber writing it down with a fucking pencil because it goes so
in
fucking
India.
Slow. And I've never seen people happier to see a technology getting trashed. People love the fact that the iPhone.
Because a lot of people see it as elitist.
Really?
Yes.
I didn't at all.
See just having an iPhone as being elitist at this point in time.
AT&T,
but
better
the fact that this is the wave of the future, because there was an article today in the paper about just getting rid of buttons. Can we just get beyond all these goddamn buttons on things and have touch screens, which are so convenient and handy? I like it. And your screen is bigger because you don't have a bunch of buttons taking up half your BlackBerry. I'm not a big fan of the BlackBerry. I had it for a week, and I was like, get this fucking thing away from me.
So annoying. I know. Every fucking text sent immediately. 98% of my calls completed. Oh, it was terrible.
I love my BlackBerry.
Oh, look at that screen. What are you seeing on that?
I like it, though.
Punch up a skateboarding dog on that and see if you can even see it.
I don't need that.
He's seeing emails from me that he doesn't reply to.
Oh, shit.
It's all right.
It's getting heavy and hot in here. Wow. Back to the message board chatter.
I do like the iPhone, though. My problem with it is...
Is that why you're not looking at me today?
No, I'm sorry, Opie.
Why didn't you return... You always return my emails sometimes.
Now I have a contact photo for Laszlo.
Oh, fuck.
That's what I do. I take all my contact photos, and then when the phone rings, I see a little picture of Laszlo, and I go, I'm taking this call, as opposed to an E-Rock call where I go, whoop. Just don't even have to accept it. I'm sure it's nothing important.
Anthony showed me his little folder on his iPhone where he had trashed he'd trashed people's calls or messages that he didn't want to listen to. He's like, oh, here's the trash bin. And the top one was Opie.
Oh, it just went right into the trash bin.
My phone call?
No.
He moved it there.
I moved it there.
Why?
I had to slide it over. I listened to it. It was a message. And then I called you back.
Oh, I thought you were insinuating that you didn't listen to his message.
I listened to the Opie message. Are you insane? It might be something important.
Do I bore you with my phone calls?
Never.
I'm sorry.
As
opposed to Bob.
When the iPhone has, you know, like 20, 40, 60 gigs of space for videos and for music...
Yeah,
that's going to be excellent. But right now, you know, solid state memory technology is not to the point where you can have those enormous hard drives. Because if you put like, you know, an iPod has a hard drive with a spinning disk.
Right.
Right. And if you put that in a phone, it's going to be dead in like an hour.
No kidding.
So once they get solid state flash memory technology, you know, up to the 40, 60 gig level, then I'll be pretty stoked. Because, I mean, I'm sure you have a ton of music, you know. Opie's probably got thousands of CDs, and it's like with 8 gig, what can you really...
No, you know what? I'm getting rid of all my CDs. I mean, XM has such great music channels, I don't really need my CDs anymore. And I blew off my iPod.
Did you?
Yeah, for the most part. I walk around with the Inno.
What are you listening to? Ethel?
Ethel, yeah, they got Ethel together. And Lucy's really good. And Squiz, they got the rock stations together finally.
You want your classics, you go to Top Tracks or Big Tracks.
But like
a couple of the decades for some fun,
everything,
some nostalgia.
Yeah, everything I need to hear is on either Lucy or Ethel at this point. Absolutely. I don't need CDs anymore. And, you know, if there's a song I really like, I save and I'll play it again when I want.
Mm.
Here we are. It's Opie and Anthony on XM Satellite Radio.
Can I tell you when Ecstasy of the Gold started?
Ecstasy of the Gold?
Isn't that what it's called?
Ecstasy of the Gold.
Whatever.
It just sounded funny how you said it. Ecstasy of the Gold. Of the Gold.
When Ecstasy of the Gold started, I decided to check my email on my iPhone.
Yes. I was going to say I love the iPhone, but I don't have an iPhone.
Fantastic iPhone.
Yeah.
It is still trying to open the sign-in page.
To,
Because they went with the slower web. Why did they go with the slow? Can somebody call me, please, a tech guy, explain why fucking Steve Jobs went with the slower web service? We know why he went with AT&T. Because they're a cunt service, and he could straddle their shoulders and fuck their mouths, and they would take it. We all know that's why he went with AT&T, because Verizon had self-esteem. They're like, no, we're not giving you a piece of the phone calls.
Can I be the moderator, by the way? I find this hilarious, because we have two main people from the Opie and Anthony show that have iPhones. Two out of the three here, right?
Yeah.
Anthony loves his iPhone.
I can't get enough of his iPhone.
Talks about it all the time to the point where, like, all right, enough about the iPhone. We get it. And then you got Jimmy in this other corner here that can't stand it. And he's minutes away from throwing it out this window.
But I will say this. Technologically, it's an amazing thing. What annoys me so, it makes me livid beyond comprehension, is that the things that I don't like about it could have been avoided. These are not technical glitches. This is a well-made, brilliant piece of technology. The calendar's great. Everything about it is great.
Mm-hmm.
But what do? They go with AT&T because they're going to get a piece of the phone calls, and they can bully AT&T. Because AT&T is basically a bunch of faggots. And they know what their job is, to get on their hands and knees, open their assholes, and say, anyone from Cupertino, come on in. No condoms required. But the web service on this, to say it sucks a dick would be to do a disservice to Larry Craig and all other men who love a cock buried in a gun.
Well, we don't know about Larry Craig.
Okay, just a guess, considering he was arrested.
I got things to pay for. I don't know that that's true about Larry Craig at this time, sir.
I say it in humor.
All right.
I will note that the
do you like the web browser there?
The browser, yeah, it could be faster. Hell yeah!
Way to put it. Mailing a letter and stapling your thoughts to a turtle's back and saying, "Go, bring it to who I need."
But my email, I'm just using the mail icon. I hit it, and here's my email.
I don't do that.
Why? That's
because
what it's set up for.
I'll tell you,
you're taking a Ferrari and using it to drive the kids to school.
No, I'm not. I'm taking a Ferrari, and I just want to go on a different road. And for some reason, the only fucking road the Ferrari goes fast on is the one road especially built in Cupertino, whereas the rest of the fucking internet is not based on that road. So it's like, and me and Sam knows more about this stuff than I do. And I think, what's it called? The one, what did they go with?
EV.
EV. Whatever the fuck that means.
Yeah.
EV.
Eventually, your shit will come. Sam, can you explain to me? And Sam raised it because I didn't know why they did it.
Can I jump on really fast?
Sure.
Ecstasy of the Gold, performed by The Motley Crue.
Ecstasy of Gold?
Ecstasy of Gold.
I don't even know, to be honest with you.
It is Ecstasy of Gold.
But just funny how you said the
I
gold.
I wanted to say it again.
Because he kind of just paused.
Of the Gold. The Gold. Sam?
Yes, Sam. Hold on. You on?
Technological whiz kid? Is that what you are now?
No, I was just saying that they went with, I think, the Edge network instead of the G3 network. And my only assumption would be that because they want to be able to put out the next iPhone and say it's 4 times faster.
Get those stock prices up with the new phone and the new announcement and the more gigs, which you could have put on the first phone. But meanwhile, first generation iPhone buyers, just open your mouth wider and take the fucking load we're going to fire down your throat. And I'm a dummy. I never go with first generation shit, but I did.
Can I be honest with you, Jimmy?
Yes, baby girl.
The reason that anybody right now is carrying around an iPhone It's a status symbol.
I'll be honest.
You wanted to be one of the first ones to have it? You got it. Here's what I gave up for an iPhone.
Yeah, service.
I gave up.
Quality. Speed. Listening to your party when they call you. I'll tell you what you gained. What? Hello. What? Hello. It's me. I'm echoing. It's me. Caulfield. 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 Hi, Caulfield.
I gave up television. I had television on my other phone. I was able to watch Fox News and everything like that. I gave up video recording. I had a video recorder. I was able to do that. I gave up the ability to text people for photographs, which I did a lot of. There's a lot of fun to do things like that. Speed. Why? To have an iPhone. I wanted to see what it was all about. I wanted to see, and I knew that the second generation one's going to be better, as will the third. It's just like the original iPod. The original iPod, if you look at it now, it sucks ass.
It was a bit clunky.
A bit clunky, exactly. Oh, clunky.
Clunky.
And now they're going to be coming out with a new one that's going to be amazing. But the next generation iPhone, and it is exactly that. They don't want to put out a product that is going to make people go, well, I'll have this for about 10 years. And then they go, okay, we'll just shut our doors. Goodbye, we're out of business. So they fuck you with the first one.
Sure.
And then they slowly build it better and better. Remember when the megahertz in computers used to like come out every few months? You'd get the 333 processor, the 666, and then oh my God, we're up to like a gig. It was amazing. And every fucking 6 months, you were left in the dirt. That's what they're doing.
I know. I understand that. But this is also the same company that had everything first. They're the originators.
Yeah.
And yet, Windows is in 80% of the world's computers or something like that. And I think because they didn't fucking want to license the software, they wanted to be motherfuckers. And this is what you get. And it's a great company. I'm not shitting. Not even because they sponsor the CBS site. I love my fucking Mac.
Yeah.
I love it. But this enrages me because I know what they could have done with it, and I know exactly why they did it, and I don't care about the status symbol. It actually, I was so dumb, it looked like a good product to me. It looked like you can sync it with your fucking Mac, everything's going to move quickly, you're on the internet fast, because fucking stupid, fucking Mr. Freeze, cunt face Bob Kelly.
You're blaming Bob.
Well, Bob.
Fucking pile of shit was rated dead. Dad, you go on, you open, he show me with his little fucking rotten dick-beating fingers how you go zap.
You pinch the pictures open and close, and they get bigger and smaller.
Fucking lonely fingers on the screen, you go fuck.
And
it opens up the web pages, but what fucko didn't tell me is that Wi-Fi, you can't just sign on to networks unless you have a password. Nobody has a password for every fucking cocksucking network, so if you're home, or if you're at the Comedy Cellar, like we always are, and have free Wi-Fi, boom, it's very fast.
Yeah.
But everywhere else in the world, it fucking
Well, isn't that
stinks.
Like any computer? If you're at an airport, you're going to get free Wi-Fi. If you're somewhere at some fucking upper crusty cafe that is going to want you to pay, or a hotel or something like that, you got to pay for it. But the Wi-Fi works fine when you're in a free Wi-Fi.
But they could have went with a faster one, where it wouldn't have been such a disparity.
Why is Sam awkwardly holding the mic still?
I don't know.
But
he's adorable.
And he knows how to keep a secret. I learned something today. True. And Dan is not happy about that.
Am I wrong, Sam?
No, you're not wrong.
Thank you.
What did you have before that was faster?
BlackBerry. Mm-hmm. My fucking Verizon.
Mm-hmm.
That fucking douchebag they have. Can you hear me now? I'd love him to be embroiled in some sort of a fucking internet child porn scandal. I can't tell you my disdain for that fucking guy.
Might be a bit harsh.
That's as nice as I can be. As I see his fucking dumb nerd face everywhere I go. But you know what? Verizon service is fucking great. I don't know. I'm one of these silly geese that thinks I should be able to make phone calls in Manhattan.
Wherever you are.
Just a little suburb called Manhattan that I fucking live in. Caulfield.
I got three phones in my new place, and I got to get a landline. Oh, are you having problems?
And
still?
I never wanted a landline since the cell phone thing happened.
Yeah, we're on the west
side. I got
side.
Three different phones. I got a business phone, a personal phone, and then Lindsay's got her phone. None of the phones work well in the freaking apartment.
Yeah, I had the same problem.
So now I got to get a landline on top of all this.
That's odd.
That's where we are.
It's New York City, for fuck's sake.
I don't know what that's all about, but I'm sorry about that, Jimmy.
It's okay. I feel nauseous.
And it was all during Ecstasy of the Gold.
Ecstasy of the Gold. Can I have somebody go get me some pretzel nuggets?
You all right? What happened, Jimmy?
He's just so aggravated.
Yeah. I'm so annoyed right now. But I'm also, I think I drank too much coffee and didn't eat enough.
Mm.
But I feel like I'm going to vomit, so.
All right. Make sure you vomit while we're on
the might be the rage.
It could be.
Yeah, when you get worked up,
rage, dude. When Ecstasy of Gold starts, and I'm trying to get my email real quick, and then all of a sudden we're 40 minutes into the show, and I still see that fucking faggoty ball circles going nowhere. I'm like, you know what? You could have made this better. You could have made it better, dude. That's what bothers me. If it was on Wi-Fi, I know they could have made it better. Mm-hmm. And I just think of his stupid fucking balding face and his dumb, get the fucking LASIK surgery, motherfucker. And the CEO of Apple. The fucking dumb glasses. That said,
I just know.
My PC is shit. Yes. I hated it. And I love the Apple computer. I love my Mac.
Yeah.
Love it. I'm getting a Mac desktop. Not for free, obviously, after these tirades.
I have one. I have one.
Love it.
My G5, I'm trying to hook it up to my network last night, and I just wanted to bang my fucking head against the wall. I have the worst problem with networking my computers, and it's because I don't remember what I did the time before, because I went through 10 hours of bullshit that time. So I get on, I do everything I'm supposed to do with the router and set everything up. I plug in the fucking Ethernet cable. I'm ready to go. But no internet connection. What the fuck?
But you figured it out once before.
Oh, once. Like 8 times. And each time, there were 1,000 steps of trial and error. So I don't know. It's always a fucking problem with a network. Always. So now I'll go home later before the gym. And fuck around with that and try to get that working. Computers are just, they can be, everything can be so much easier.
But you know what's great about Apple, and this is what I love about this thing. I wanted to print something the other day. All I got to do is plug in the printer and it does it.
Oh,
fuck
yeah.
Windows and their faggoty drivers and fuck you.
Download all kinds of shit.
And
right.
The new hardware wizard. Did it really find new hardware? Good, because I plugged it in. We all knew it was there. It wasn't a secret.
Wizard.
The fuck, but no, the new hardware wizard. Guess what I found? I don't know, jerk off. The thing I plugged in with the USB. You fucking cunt.
We have located the hardware. Yeah, I bought it. I put it next to the computer. Why are you bragging that you found it?
Exactly.
I just plugged it in.
With your nice wizardry.
The wizardry.
There's some wizardry.
I used all of my wizardry and I located the thing you plugged in. My fucking Mac doesn't brag. I plug it in. It's understood that it's going to locate shit because it's a fucking computer and that's what it does.
That is so funny. It's like, Windows has located a new piece of hardware.
How amazing. Maybe I should brag. And the human plugged the fucking thing in.
I bought it, fucko.
Exactly. And I didn't put my foot through your screen, which I easily could have and should have done.
You needy piece of shit.
Well, what's the exclamation point in the yellow box? Conflict. Port number 3207 is in use. Try fucking find. What?
Why can't they just have ports A, B, C, and D? That's what all USB should be. A, B, C, and
make
color coded. What?
Just you know what? You're right.
I don't know. Something.
I can't open. That. I have AOL, and I know it's archaic, but I've been using it for years. And I use a regular Explorer.
It's training wheels.
And I know, but I still like it. But I don't use it for everything, just basically email.
It's adorable.
My AOL will just not open on my Mac. For some reason, AOL for Mac, it works in other places, but it's something to do with my internet connection. My girlfriend and I cannot video conference. Video conferencing on Mac is great. Like, when you're away, you just boot it up and you fucking video conference with your
friend. Yeah, the iChat thing.
You're jerking off within minutes.
jacking.
Thank you. You're jacking.
Is exactly what it is and what you do.
The wizard found an erection.
Well, I don't like the fact. Yes.
Put your dick in your. I've detected cum on my monitor.
Does your computer locate your jacking?
What I don't like about it is that the I have to get an external camera because the camera is built in.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
To the top.
So you got to tilt the.
Now I have to type while the fucking camera's aimed at my cock. So you can see my fucking little chubby legs splayed out on the bed and my hands typing. And I'm one over on the keyboard, so I'm not typing right. I'd love to asterisk 3-5 kill you.
What? Yeah, what? Excuse me. Keith from Long Island, he writes, Apple went with Edge 2.5G instead of the UMTS/HSDPA 3G because 3G requires a lot more power and would drain the battery much quicker, and Apple wanted to proclaim a long battery life. The battery would die 30% quicker if it was a 3G.
Well, then how about this?
This guy lives in his mother's basement.
Thank God for that guy. And how about this, Apple? Instead of worrying about the battery life and the stock price, you can fucking brag. How about you make a fucking attachment for it that gives longer battery life? Or how about you make the battery fucking replaceable so I can fucking charge one while one is in use like I could with all my other fucking phones, so you have a battery that you can take off? Why does the battery... Where was I in these
Everything's
meetings?
Enclosed.
Oh, cow.
They
perfect.
Don't want you poking around in there.
Oh, the only people I can touch. Take us to the genius bar, though.
I'm a genius
Let's
bar.
Let's go to the genius bar. What time's your next class at the genius bar? I'm having problems. Genius bar.
They got the genius bar. They have a problem, you go down there, and there's people qualified to take care of your needs.
And they are. By far, their customer service blows away those shit dicks that I had to deal with at Dell. I'm sorry, but they
time
fucking...
to start writing. What about the spy sweeper?
Spy sweeper.
What do you think of the spy sweeper on your computer?
I don't know what this. That's one thing I love about Windows. Whenever I boot it up, fucking McAfee, fucking jerk off antivirus thing just starts scanning, and I keep telling it, stop scanning.
Stop it already.
You motherfucker. It was off. It didn't pick up any viruses when it was off.
Every time you turn that fucker on, it comes on. Would you like to download this? Would you like to scan? And I go, no. And then it goes, the next time you boot it up or you look at it, boom, there it is again. So I go, all right, I'll tell you when. Would you like to remind? You can remind me when to fucking whatever. So I click it and I go, 2 days. That's the longest they let you go. And then it comes back. Hello, McAfee.
McAfee would like to remind you. I remember.
Do you take advantage of reporting errors?
No.
Oh, my God, that one. Would you like to report? I like that. You get the crash. You Control-Alt-Delete. And then you're like, would you like to report this?
Yeah.
Who the fuck
like
is reading eight gazillion reports that have to be pouring in?
Right. Anthony from Long Island.
Yeah, oh, let me look at this one.
This has got to be
this is serious.
Message.
He was looking at the New York radio message board, and his Explorer crashed for a second.
Do the same thing, or is it just McAfee?
Norton antivirus.
I don't think I had the problems with Norton. I think McAfee is just... You know what McAfee is? It's a fucking nudge. McAfee is a nudge.
A nudge.
I'm going to scan, and I'd rather eat it in a slower than that. But you did say 2 days ago that I could scan it today. I know that. I didn't mean it. I was just trying to shut you up. But you did kind of promise that I could.
Nudge.
It's a shoulder tapping program. Excuse me. We'd like to. I'm protected. I'm fine. But what about you? What about your firewall? It's fine. Thank you. Did you update the info? Yes.
Yeah.
Leave me alone. Like a Jewish mother. I forgot to tell you. All right.
There are new viruses that you may not have downloaded the cures for.
Did you know that we've been doing some... We know. I'm okay.
Put on a coat. It's cold outside.
I'm trying.
I'm not on Kazaa downloading horse dick sucking videos. .exe. I understand.
What about pop-up blockers? Yeah, big fan of the pop-up blockers.
They never get old. I need one program. Hey, how about AOL? Stop with the fucking spy this and the spy that. I have antivirus for that.
Yeah.
I'm going to get rid of McAfee. McAfee, you know what it is? It can fucking eat my asshole. That's my official McAfee line.
You should send that report in.
Eat my asshole?
Eat my asshole. I'm going with Norton.
Yeah.
Can we play the Matt Besser phone call now? The tech support call?
Yeah. Oh,
remember
please.
The Jimmy Stewart guy?
Oh, that guy rules.
This guy rules.
Keep your chin up.
Imitating Jimmy Stewart. He's like the tech support. Some lady had a problem.
Yeah.
Oh, and the AOL cancellation. Yeah, we haven't played that in a while.
Yep.
Yeah, we got some fun.
Oh, that's always fun.
Which one you want to do? The
I went through that AOL cancellation thing myself because I had noticed that I had been paying for AOL. Two AOL accounts. And I think this is how AOL like makes their money. I've been paying for two AOL accounts for 10 years.
Right.
I stopped using AOL probably 8 years. So for eight years I was paying for two accounts that I never even ever used.
Did you try to cancel them?
Yeah, finally, I would just because it was on my Amex. And I was just like, I just would let it go. I wouldn't even look. Or I'd be like, you know, maybe I'll use it. Or I just never thought about it. So I called him up and I said, I want to cancel these two. Why? Because I never use it. Never use it. Well, you're coming around to a billing cycle that really, you get another month here. So if you want to cancel after that month, you could call back. No.
Cancel?
Cancel it right now.
Now.
Can we give you 3 months free? And I was like, no, I want this canceled right now. Dude, they wouldn't cancel it. To the point where I got off the phone after about an hour with total confidence that the accounts were canceled. And then the next bill that showed up,
it was
billed again. I still had AOL. They're amazing at how they will not cancel your fucking account.
You got to get the name of these and I call them shit heaps, for lack of a better term. But they really are. Just picture it, not even pieces of shit, because a piece is nice and tapered and kind of looks better than you think it will on your chest. But a shit heap is like a vegan shit.
It's a heap.
It's all fucking feta cheese. I don't know if vegans even eat cheese. Whatever. Fuck vegans. They're shit heaps. Get their name immediately. Hi, and who am I speaking to? They'll be happy to give it to you.
Oh.
And then once you got the name, record the conversation, too. I got to figure out how to hook up this phone thing where I can record conversations.
Yeah.
Because then you just blast them on the air.
Yeah. We can play the Jimmy Stewart tech call.
Yeah, play that, and then the AOL cancellation.
They're saying that we played it during our vacation, but come on, man.
Shit. I didn't hear it.
I didn't hear it, and our names are on the marquee.
On.
I mean, I haven't heard that bit in a long time. All right, we'll start with the Jimmy Stewart tech call.
Yeah.
This is Matt Besser. He's a very funny guy. He used to be part of Upright Citizens Brigade.
Is that who that is?
Yeah.
Was he really a tech guy?
No, what happened was he was just a dude, you know, hanging out in his apartment. His number was very close to tech support, so he just said, you know what, fuck it. I'm going to
start recording him.
And started recording this shit.
Oh, God, that's fucking
great. Yeah.
UCB is a great little place was it 28th Street in New York?
I don't know.
Fucking great shows there, man.
Yeah.
Well, here's Matt Besser.
Tech support.
Hi. I'm trying to get on the Barnes & Noble line, and I can't.
Oh, what's your problem?
The problem is that every time I try to dial it, it comes up that they can't get through and to call tech support.
We gotta be more specific, but we're gonna get through this. We're gonna turn this thing around.
Great.
Do you use your toolbar?
Yeah, I guess. What's the toolbar?
Well, you gotta use your toolbar. That's where your icons are that we're gonna have to use. I'll fix this problem. We're going to get through this, though. Just got to keep your chin up.
Okay, I hope so.
You have a Mac or on the PCs?
I have a PC. I have a disk.
Oh, that's good. It's a fine instrument.
I also have the disk. You know, I have the Barnes & Noble disk.
Oh, you got the disk?
Yeah, and it's...
Oh, with the disk? Oh, that's great. That's great.
It's not working.
The sun's on the horizon. We're going to turn this thing around.
Great.
Okay. Put your disc in.
service in?
Okay, I'll boot up your computer. You have to restart your computer.
Okay, I gotta go to shut down.
That's where your telephone is. You gotta grab hold of it.
Okay, shut down, restart.
Grab a hold of your toolbar.
Okay, I have that. Now, do you want me to go to restart?
Okay, you gotta stay focused now. Don't get all upset.
No, I'm not.
All right, now, you gotta just turn it off, but then you're gonna see the restart. Now, you check restart.
Okay, you want me to press... Okay, I understand what you're saying. You want me to say press shut down or restart?
Restart.
Okay.
You gotta stay focused, hey? You lose your cool.
Okay, you're making me confused, though, so I'm...
No, well, take a breath.
I'm taking a breath.
All right, just calm down, take a breath.
So I press restart.
Yeah, well, calm down now. You can't yell at me here.
I'm not yelling at you.
Okay.
It's frustrating.
What's happening?
www.dell.com came up on my screen. So it'll be a minute or two now.
Okay.
Making all noises and what have you. But I left the CD in there. Is that good or should I take it out?
A CD-ROM, right?
Yep.
I stick a music CD in there.
No, it's not a music CD.
I'm not joking.
No,
it'll break your computer.
Oh, no.
It's like throwing vinegar on a horse's ass.
Really? Well, that's a new expression on me. I hadn't heard that one.
Excuse me?
I haven't heard that, throwing vinegar on a horse's ass before.
Well, try it. You're going to get kicked in your head.
I guess so. I don't spend much time around horses, so it wouldn't be something I know.
Yeah. If you don't spend time around horses, you end up making a jackass out of your own self.
Well, that could be. Where are you located now?
Houston.
Oh, Houston? Okay, well.
Well, what?
Well, that's...
Where are you from?
New York City.
That's right, the 212.
Right, so, you know, we don't have a lot of horses around.
Yeah, but you got a lot of jackasses up there.
Well, that's for sure.
That's for sure.
We're looking at 10 inches of snow on Saturday.
I say you don't look at the 10 inches. You step out in there, you get out there, and you work. You shove off that snow and turn things around.
You're right. Okay, now... It came up here. Yahoo Messenger cannot connect.
Yahoo, hee-haw.
At the end of the call?
Yeah, there's no real good ending.
Yeah, but
it's still really funny,
it's
man.
It's the trip.
It's the trip on that one.
That
yeah.
is great.
People are suggesting that Rocco should be tech support.
Dude, turn on your computer, dude.
We should try to get... Sorry, maybe Matt Besser has some... more calls that he has.
Yeah, he probably does. Like, I'm sure if he had that number that was close there. That is damn funny.
And Brian, grab your toolbar.
Toolbar. By the way, while we're on break, Adam reminded me of something because I forgot. I didn't realize it until I had a... I was so naive, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is like an iPod as well as a phone. It's everything. So I say to myself, you know what, Jimbo? You got your iPod slash phone. I have a few tunes on here.
Uh-huh.
I say, while I'm down at the Comedy Cellar the other night, let me pop in my old headphones, which I brought along.
Mm-hmm.
This way I can go to... Because they do have Wi-Fi there, so I can watch some YouTube, listen to some music. But what I didn't realize is that when they sell you the iPhone... They don't tell you that if you want to use... See, I can't use the headphones they give you with these things because I have fucking fetus ears. So I can only use special headphones. I can't use those. They hurt my head.
The earbuds.
You can use the buds.
Cannot use them.
Aww.
They hurt me. So if you want to use any other headphones on the planet... Why would they fit? You gotta buy an adapter.
Oh, because there's a little divot in there.
It's recessed.
Yeah, it's recessed.
One more way to dig a few more fucking dollars.
Shekels.
Just, you know what? We didn't fuck you hard enough on this first generation. How about a couple of more shekels? Well, you want to listen to your own headphones, do you? Fuck you. Yeah. Pay me.
After I come on you, I'm going to spit in your eye.
That is exactly what it is. I know I said I'd tell you when I'm coming, but I didn't, and you swallowed it.
Whoops.
Now here's some that's left over on my helmet. Clean it up with your hair. So you can't fucking... You gotta buy a special adapter.
Mm-hmm.
Of course. Just another way to stick their dick down your throat. And I love the fact that everybody thinks Apple is this fucking amazingly hip company. They are as savage and as business-oriented as any company ever has
been.
All right.
No hippie organization anymore.
Cupertino! We live in Cupertino. Shitty name for a town. You know what I call it? Should be called
Fuckville.
Yeah, Fuckville. Or Shit Heap Town.
Shit Heap. Oh.
I was trying to calm Jimmy down. We haven't calmed him down in a while.
No.
We got Jimmy's calming music, but looks like he's calm now.
Yeah.
All right, I feel all right.
All right, good.
I've been better.
From Steve Jobs himself.
Steve Jobs.
Over 100 million iPods sold.
Excellent.
That's coming in today.
I have a fun fact from Steve Jobs as well.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
That if you want to download info on the iPhone, just write a letter.
Hey, you were talking about that that cell phone thing.
Oh, God, yes. The AT&T deal with iPhone. And I was reading in the paper that some gentleman went on a cruise, I guess, and got back, and his bill for his iPhone through AT&T was over $1,200. Wow. So I'm like, wow, you know, I was roaming and out of the country when I was in the Bahamas. And I wonder what my bill is. And one of the convenient, handy things on the iPhone is the fact that you can indeed check your bill right there on your phone.
Oh, cool.
You just go to settings and phone and, you know, things like that, and it'll check your bill. So I went to check mine. And for a month, which I already pay, I got the $100 plan, which is unlimited data. They talk about how you get this unlimited data for $100, text, all that good stuff. Well, my bill is $550.
Oh, wow. For one week, yes.
We were gone
for a week.
Yeah. That was for the week. Yeah, aside from the $100 for the month. So $450 was for 1 week because of data transfers over the roaming. 125 of that was when Iraq decided it was a good time to send me all of my pictures that I had taken here in the studio.
So
it was a lot of data. But the thing is, there was nothing... and a lot of people, I've read a lot of stuff on the message boards going, well, dummy, you know, if you read your contract, what... If one person read their entire phone contract, I will fucking blow you.
Well, and even that, if you don't.
That's that probably didn't make it over FM.
Well.
Probably didn't.
You're a bit upset.
But I said that if one person actually reads
their
contract.
That's what you said.
Another way to say it. Yeah. I'd be amazed.
Let me translate. That's good. You would be amazed.
Anthony said if somebody read their entire phone bill, I'd behave no differently than normal.
That's what he said. That's right. That's what you missed.
No one reads the entire contract. Not the phone bill, dummies. I mean, I read my entire phone bill, but the contract itself on the limitations of roaming with data charges where you can't shut off your incoming data. It's just this odd thing where if I had known that just having my phone on in the Bahamas was going to amount to a $550 phone bill, I probably would have turned it off because I wasn't able to make any incoming or outgoing calls. So why the hell did I need it?
It's brilliant that they figured out how to get more money from their customers without them knowing it.
Now, a gentleman like myself, I can suck it up and go, you know, all right, I learned, I made a mistake there, I should have shut it off or whatever. But there are people that is a huge hit. You're not going to be able to pay a $550 phone bill like that.
Mm.
So they are under a class action suit right now. It's being filed against Apple and AT&T that this was misleading, that the contract said that it's unlimited data, and there seems to be a problem when you roam, and there's no warning that these roaming charges are gigantic. And that's what I went through.
That is amazing if you think about it.
Yeah, I've had other phones where that I went away and went roaming, and it wasn't nearly as much.
Mm-hmm.
But wow. Oh, they are screwing up by the numbers with this thing.
AT&T and stuff?
Yeah.
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 They weren't ready.
Apparently not. They should have been able to go with other carriers, too. With other carriers. Screw. Why be tied up to AT&T? Should have been able to get other Verizon or something or any other carrier.
I wonder if Apple will somehow find a way to get out of it, because I'm sure that they didn't count on AT&T just blundering everything.
They should have an option where you can pop out your SIM chip and perhaps get an overseas one if you're going overseas, or, you know, pop one of those in. But nothing. That thing is sealed up, and you get your bill, and a lot of people have been calling up saying, hey, this is a lot more than I thought I was going to be paying. And they say, you know something? Sorry, pay your bill. So, go pay my bill.
But there you go.
Not happy.
Wait, you called and they said that?
No, somebody, I was reading reports and stuff and message board stuff, and they said they called and said, this is a mistake. It was roaming, but I have no way to shut this off, and I didn't know incoming data. I wasn't making any phone calls. It's not like I was on the phone for 3 hours talking to somebody back in the States. Your phone sits there, and every so often it gets an email, and it downloads it.
And you're paying through the
and
nose
you're paying
for that.
Through the nose that your phone's just sitting there.
That's brilliant.
On charge.
I mean, I would be pissed, but that's brilliant that the company has figured out how to get more money out of their customers.
Yeah.
Who's going to fight it?
Oh, because you figure if you're paying, like, there are two plans. There was a cheaper one and then the more expensive $100 plan. So I go for the $100 plan. Figure, you know, you're going to get it, everything you need. So you're paying that $100, but now you're also paying $450 extra on top of it.
Yeah.
But if it's $100, let me ask you, like, I think I have that plan too.
Yeah.
What my bill so far as of September 11th is $167.
How does that happen,
like,
Jimmy?
What's the $67?
Where does $67 come from when it said $100? This is all
taxes, service charges.
FICA,
probably FICA's involved.
FICA. I hate FICA.
Let's go to Bob in Florida. Bob.
Hey there, Bob.
Hey, Bob.
I would like to have a special request for Relax by Frankie Goes to Hollywood.
80s New Wave. That's good. That's good.
Frankie says relax.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, and we all know what he's talking about.
Frankie says lose a lot of weight.
Frankie says just relax.
Yeah.
Give it to me.
Frankie says the test was positive.
80s New Wave.
What? Oh, Frankie's dead.
Is he?
I don't know if he's dead.
Frankie's dead.
Frankie
got the AIDS, didn't he?
That's a new band. I don't know he's dead.
Fan?
I don't think Frankie's dead.
Oh, my God.
What?
Travis, our own Travis.
Yeah.
His first international phone bill was $2,800.
What?
Wowie kazowie. And that wasn't on an iPhone, was it?
Travis, take your time going to the microphone.
What service was it?
No problem. I guess it's all about you today.
What service was it?
We're already 4 minutes late, and you just take your time.
It was Verizon.
It was Verizon, so, wow, they still nail you.
Yeah, the first month I started talking to Lisa.
Oh, up in Canada.
I didn't know that that long distance did not include Canada.
Yeah, but wait, you're still here in the United States, and right. You were just calling Canada.
Mm-hmm.
And they charge you $2,800?
Yeah.
The technology's there to not have to charge that much money.
Isn't that just a regular?
That's a regular international phone call.
Yeah, Canada's regular.
Zero, they get you.
Yeah.
So like, what did you do?
65 cents a minute. My dad paid it, and I paid him back over 14 months.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
They immediately shut your phone off when it's that much.
Why is it that much?
Because they have to, like, turn, like, special switches on and off.
No, they don't.
Yeah, they do.
No, they do
They
not.
Really do. They know that you're calling another company, and there's a guy that's sitting there going, oh, boy, okay, what do I have to do? I got to push B, C, A, I got to move this lever up, and then you talk.
Wow, that must be a lot of lever moving.
There's a lot of people that all they do is lever moving.
You know what? And you know why I say that? Because you can pick up your phone at home and call Canada for nothing.
Yeah.
Why is it different with a cell phone?
There's like five different charges. It's ridiculous. There's just a charge. It's like 65 cents a minute.
Why are they still ripping people off with cell phone charges? Cell phones are pretty commonplace these days.
How great.
And there's no need. There's none of this extra equipment that needs all this maintenance.
No, they got to call like a guy in a tower.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, Travis needs to call Canada, so get ready. And then the guy in Canada goes, all right, let me get the levers.
Okay, Travis, I'll put your call through.
Let me get all the levers situated in the right way.
What's all this about? Who's your calling?
Oh man, has the internet exploited the cell phone companies or what? They showed everybody how easy it is to just, you know, communicate with someone anywhere in the world, but the cell phone companies made it sound like it was very complicated.
Oh, it's so complicated. It's a goddamn phone call. Just stop it. They're ripping everyone off.
Wasn't there a class action suit? Did you say that already? Against AT&T? There's some kind of
Right now, there's a class action suit against AT&T because of these roaming charges on the iPhone. Because their contract was misleading, is what the lawsuit says.
Jesse has this comment. Jesse from Arizona. Yes.
Yeah, I'm right here. Hold on. What's going on?
Why did you say hold on?
Yeah.
Because I had to take it off speakerphone, man. I'm sitting out here. I'm in Arizona.
All right. What do you got going on in Arizona?
About Mickey's 40 halfway through. Am I allowed to say that on the radio?
No, but you did. So
whatever.
I guess we'll just have to let that go through. Yeah.
Cool. So we were talking earlier about 9/11, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are we still going to talk about that at all, or are we going to talk about Britney's muffin?
This guy.
Well, we talked about Britney's muffin as well.
Yeah.
There's only so much you could say about Britney Spears and how she looked a bit chubby on stage the other night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And she was wearing
another thing is, too, is Verizon and AT&T are on the same towers. They just fuck you one way or another. Oh, shit, I can't say that.
Oh my God. Worst caller ever.
Jesse.
All right.
You can't say the F word and then to follow up the F word you go, I can't say that.
It was an F.
You were saying that Verizon and AT&T are on the same tower, so they kind of screw you over. But I for me the difference would be, and I could be wrong, but Verizon has landlines, and that makes a huge difference. For whatever reason, Verizon service is just is the best.
Well, I'll tell you, yesterday I was waiting to watch my NFL Sunday Ticket, and I was on the phone with DirecTV for 2 hours trying to get that to work. I'll tell you one thing. There's no such thing as customer service in America anymore because we're talking to somebody in India.
Wait, you were watching your football on Monday?
Well, don't most people watch Monday Night Football? I'm talking about yesterday.
Yeah, but you made it sound like you didn't he say NFL tickets, so you would want to check out all the games instead of one game? You really meant to say on Sunday, didn't you? But then again, it's Arizona. Is it still Monday in Arizona?
I don't know where that timeline is. It's
all right, Jesse. You know, we really gave you a shot, but you just suck.
And that was the worst. What he just said, he goes, you know, there really is no more customer service in America. That was the worst mass email opening I've ever heard.
Yeah.
But let's
George Carlin's views on customer service.
But let's give it to Arizona. They do have the lakes where the chicks get naked on boats.
Thank you for reminding me of that, E-Rock. Spring break things going on over there.
They do have those lakes with the chicks on the boats. Hey, we were talking about phones. Before we move on, we got Mike from Illinois. Ant's confused. iPhone data never shuts off. Browser is always open, not just for the mail? What? His feedback fell apart at the end, but they're saying that the data never shuts off. So if you're in a foreign country, you're getting charged a ridiculous sum of money when your phone is off.
Someone suggested something very convenient. Said, before you go on vacation, call AT&T and have them shut your service off.
Oh, great.
And then have them turn it back on when you get home. That's convenient because you know how easy it is, first of all, to call a cell phone company and actually get somebody that knows what the hell they're talking about and not just to press 1, press 2, press 3. And then turn off your service and then turn it back on when you just leave your cell phone at home, dummy.
They know they got you. That's why I say, once again, it's brilliant.
Yep.
It's brilliant. Mike from South Jersey, a guy left his iPhone off and they still charged him $4,800 because when it's turned off, it still checks for email updates and other S.
No.
Do you know, I'm looking at the cost of my iPhone right now.
Yeah.
And I have a $99 a month thing, 2,000 minutes.
So $99. That's nice.
And then it's just that you get a bill every month for $99.
You could probably set it up instantly just to pay it right from your account.
Well, write that old check for $99.
$99,
Jim.
Zero
over 100.
Nope.
No?
What? Wait, no. Oh, no.
Why?
It says $99.
iPhone data plus UNL, it might be unlimited, $40.
So maybe, but you have unlimited data.
Well, that might be part of it. Like, I may have signed up for $139. I could live with that.
I don't think so. I think $100 includes the unlimited data.
Yeah.
Well, then I don't know what the charge... I could be... Because right here,
you didn't read your contract.
30 cents for the wireless 911 charge. Okay, New York State fee. Of course, they have to get their disgusting fingers in there. $1.20, and then here I don't get this one. Regulatory cost recovery charge.
Oh well, that's to recover the regulatory cost.
The regulatory cost.
What is that?
That means that the government passed something on to the despicable phone companies, I think, and
they have to recover it. Through the through you.
Why don't they just come to our houses, put guns in our faces, and say, hand it over.
Just give me your money. Oh, you're using our phone.
Jimmy.
Give me your money.
They can't do that because we're free in this country.
Right.
We're going to build a freedom tower to show the rest of the world we're free.
I like the word freedom. Yeah. Not used enough.
They better put a cell up there.
You got tranny charges on that thing, too?
Let's hope not. $15.99, Daddy.
Tranny charge.
Hey, Lou's a big tech guy, right? You have the iPhone.
Yeah, I got an iPhone.
All right, Jimmy.
I don't pay my bills. They just turned it off.
Jimmy hates the iPhone. Ant loves the iPhone. Where are you in the middle? You hate it too.
And Louis is a Mac. He got me into Mac. Yeah. Louis is a Mac guy. Louis,
you know what? I like the iPhone. I like it.
You don't love it.
I don't love it.
You did.
There are many things.
From having a BlackBerry and it doesn't do what a BlackBerry does.
See, I didn't have a BlackBerry. I can't stand the phone.
A BlackBerry.
This is the easiest thing I've texted on, though. It goes to tell you.
That will make me
a BlackBerry. BlackBerry.
BlackBerry.
BlackBerry.
I like the texting on it. I really do.
You like to type it on the fucking
on the touchscreen. It's better than fucking typing three, like, because I usually just get like a flip phone, and for A or B,
it's
C,
like tap, tap,
I got
tap.
1, 2, 3. Go back.
Yeah, that's what BlackBerry's been there for like fucking 10 years now. It's great.
Yeah, but they're too big, and
my wife has a phone.
There's no cover on the fucking thing. I'm spitting.
My wife has a phone that's not a PDA.
Yeah,
it's just a cell phone, but it has the whole.
Has a keyboard
on. Yeah. And those are the ideal because they don't crash. They don't drop C. You know, you don't have too much information on it. Just.
I think the second or third generation iPhone
has a huge amount of limitations that are stupid.
That shouldn't. They shouldn't have.
Well, he could have had faster web browsing.
You can't search your emails.
I know.
You can't search your emails. You can't cut paste and cut your emails. You can copy a piece from one email and put it in another.
That is annoying.
It's crazy. You can't type, like, if you turn it sideways, the keyboard will go sideways, but only when you're web browsing.
Yeah, you can't do it in mail.
You can't turn an email sideways, which is the only time you'd ever really want to.
Right.
It's really dumb. And then they made these new iPods.
No picture texting.
These new iPods that you can use the wireless to get music off of iTunes. There's no reason the iPhone can't do that. It's the exact same hardware.
Same thing that they're using. They just took the phone feature
out
of it.
That's all it is. An iPod and an iPhone now is the exact same stuff with just different shit turned on or off.
So why the fuck can't I download shit onto my iPhone?
Because Steve Jobs is a cunt.
Have I not been saying that?
Why. Yes, you have.
I have been saying in those words that he is a cunt.
He's a cunt. He made four things now that you have to buy all of them. There's a Nano, a classic iPod, an iPod video, and an iPhone, and they all, none of them all do
this
one
motherfucker
thing. You have to buy all four of them to make, and he carry could them have made them all them. Do the same thing.
All in one thing, they could have done
asshole.
That. You know what, I got my my bill from AT&T, because of course that's the only company that you can use with the iPhone.
Yeah.
I got my bill. I happened to be in the Bahamas for a week.
Mm-hmm.
And
I know what happened. I know what happened.
Yes, of course you do.
It was getting your junk emails. By the way, there's no email filter.
No filter.
So it gets your junk emails, and you got what? I got a $2,000 phone bill for 1 week in Montreal.
$2,000. Okay. No, not even close. Good. No. I mean, you got way over me.
So how the fuck?
Mine was $560.
How the fuck do they get away with that?
There's class action suit. They won't, I don't think.
Well, I could have called and complained, but it's too late now. Because add to that that I'm a lazy,
disorganized
idiot.
So you just didn't pay.
This woman said,
but they're counting on people to be lazy and not fight this shit.
Yes, they are.
And they're like, oh, fuck, I'll just write the check.
That's it. That's what I did. Yeah, I had to. And I
actually,
no, it's worse than that. I didn't pay it, and they turned off the phone, and now
they
got a collection agency.
That's so wonderful.
They are fucking cocksuckers.
For something you had no idea about.
Because of that.
For something you had no idea about.
I really didn't have any idea about that roaming thing. I know I've had phones that roam. This is my first fucking cell phone. When I go overseas and I see that it's roaming, I'll turn off roaming unless I got to make a call or check my email. And then there was no way to turn that on and off where you're... No. you're not getting fucked from for
and
data
they
transfer.
Brag that it's a complete version of OS 10 or whatever. It's not. It's,
no.
It's it doesn't have a, you can't store any stuff on it. You can't can't like get a file. You can't a million things that you can do with BlackBerry. You can't like you can use a Verizon cell phone to get on the internet with your computer with with your Mac. It's very hard to find a phone that'll do that. Finally, Mac makes a fucking phone. You can't use it as a modem.
No.
You can't do it.
The Heist, though, their internet speed stinks. They could have had a faster one. They went with the slower one.
That's awful.
I agree.
Let's go to Jeff
and
Virginia.
Louis got me into Mac, so he fucking... Yeah.
I still the computer.
So he fucked
great.
You, is what
their
you're
computers
saying.
Yeah, I love the computers.
Yeah.
Hey, Jeff, what's up?
Phone's kind of pissing me off.
Guys.
Hey.
Oh.
Well, I don't like the non-video. I get no video.
Yeah.
Hold on, Jeff. Go ahead.
Text. Go ahead, Jeff.
No, you guys are talking about what a cunt Steve Jobs is. Of course he's a cunt. Bill Gates fucked him so hard back in the day. He will never let it happen again. Never. He's going to lock everything down. You're going to buy everything from him if you wanted all to work together.
Well, he should have been a little bit better with licensing his stuff, and he would have had it into more computers.
He could have let people make Mac clones, and everything would have been different. He's a dumbass.
He is a dope.
I met him once. I was in a store buying the new 12-inch when they first came out with that 12-inch aluminum book, and I went to the first store that had it in the world.
Yeah,
I'm so obsessed.
Yeah,
and I found out they had one in Sacramento, and I drove out to Sacramento from LA to look at this thing, and it was shitty. I didn't like it.
Oh wow!
And he came to the store because he was there to oversee all the new displays.
How disappointing!
Stuff.
After driving all the fucking way up there.
So I went up to him, and like he had a crowd of people around him, and he's like God to them. And I just walk up and I said, hey, this is a pretty disappointing product.
Oh, no,
and
you were that
everybody
guy.
Everybody around him goes, oh, whoa.
Hey,
like, no,
hey.
Don't talk to him that way. And I'm like, I don't work for him. What, is he going to fire me? And he goes, what are you talking about? And I said, I'm really disappointed. And he goes, you don't know what you're talking about. I go, well,
I
drove here like a few hours to buy this and I don't like it. I mean, I'm just looking at it and it just doesn't seem that nice. And he goes, well, I could have charged you $200 more and made it better. And I was like, I would have paid it.
Yeah,
it's not about
money.
Saying
it sucks.
Yeah, it's just not that great. And he goes, well, buy the 15-inch one. I'm like, I will because I need the thing. But it's just too. I'm just telling you, it's just too bad. You could have done a better machine. And the people around him were just so fucking bummed.
Well, he's probably one of those guys that is too. You know, he's a brilliant guy, obviously, but he probably doesn't listen to stuff like that. And it's hurt him financially. It's stupid.
Yeah,
the iPhone could have been amazing.
Yeah,
but he
wanted
stuff off on purpose. And that
exactly. I wanted everything to be on there. I wanted it to have video. I wanted it to have the ability to text pictures. Like when I send a text message, I want to attach a picture to it.
Yeah,
you know, can't do that.
No,
can't
when
get
you want,
pictures.
When you try to find, like, if you're in an email and you start writing an email to somebody, you start writing their name and it finds the name.
Yeah,
like
right.
The way you should. But if you're calling somebody, it doesn't fucking do that. You have to scroll through those tiny
letters on the side.
And you got to scroll through. If you have 50 people with the first letter A, you got to scroll through all that shit.
Yeah.
I mean, what the fuck?
Yeah, you can't.
And you
search
know
for
they
number.
Can
if,
do
on
it.
The YouTube. It's only like a certain percentage of the clips because of a bunch of them, it won't play.
It won't play it, yeah.
And none of my YouTube clips
they
play
won't
on an
show
iPhone.
Up.
They don't show up because they're using a certain flash technology instead of whatever else.
They tried to sell it as if it was like, wow, look at this. You're getting a computer in your hand as far as the web browsing goes.
Nope.
Hey, it just ain't it.
Some dog shit sniffer from Woodside. Steve Jobs, what a dumbass. He's only worth half a Bill Gates' fortune.
So what? He's rich.
And then Jason,
he's got probably $10,000, $20,000 in the bank.
Perhaps more than that, Ant.
And then you got Jason from Cal Class.
Have it on this one.
I'm streaming XM from my iPhone so I can listen to you in class. There isn't much this thing can't do.
Yes, except
there's a lot of things that can't
do. I'll tell you what it can't do. Get online in under 45 minutes so I can fucking go to check my AOL mail or something else I want to check. Or look at
you being on AOL is fucking sad.
I'm a cunt too. I'm not saying I'm not. I'm not saying I'm not. But how about put a little bit more fucking hard drive space on it? He could have done that. He didn't want to.
There's no hard drive in it.
That's what, remember, well, before it came out, we were here saying that it's a really good iPod, even if you don't use it as a phone.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
No.
It's got a tenth of space. regular iPods have 80 gigabytes.
Yeah.
This has 8 gigabytes.
Mm-hmm.
I put my shows, I record every show I do, and I put them on my iPod to listen to. I can fit 3 hour-long shows, and it's fucking full. It's a piece of shit. Fucking faggots.
Well, I brought it.
If you have an iPhone, whoever's listening in class, you're a faggot in your class. Listen in your faggot iPhone. Fucking shove it up your ass and come out of your dick into your own face.
Well, I brought up faggot. The whole iPhone thing to lead to a clip from 1967.
Mm. 1967?
Wow. They're talking
born.
About the future.
The future?
The future.
What was going to happen in the future?
1967 film called 1999 AD.
Wow, that was the future.
Which is now what, 8 years ago?
Yep. Wow.
Which predicts online shopping, banking, and email.
No way.
1967, wow. Talking about the future.
Fingertip shopping will be one of the many homemaker's conveniences. This video console will be channeled into the store of her choice. There, a camera will scan a display of wares, which she will select by push button.
She won't have to deal with Negroes.
That's true, though.
That's
I mean, what you said.
Another part of this console is a household monitor screen, which maintains a watch on critical areas in the house, swimming pool, or yard.
I like that.
That's what everybody had a swimming pool.
What the wife selects
pool.
On her console will be paid for by the husband at his counterpart console. All bills and transactions will be carried
can't
out.
Can't trust her.
No.
She'll buy her feminine products and things to make black eyes go away.
Wow, man. The husband will pay for herself.
We'll pay. Yeah. Don't let her go crazy. Okay. See what happened? They even knew back then.
So he... Part of the integrated system was that
1967.
There's a whole separate console for the husband.
For the husband
to watch
so like,
over
that's
the
like the pilot
purchases.
Seat.
Oh my
and
god!
And she's just in the co-pilot seat.
Well, oh I want to hear the last part.
You
again.
Don't want her to, you know, have oh say over what god. She can buy.
Hold on.
Areas in the house, swimming pool, or yard. What the wife selects on her console will be paid for by the husband at his counterpart console.
Oh, my God.
All bills and transactions will be carried out electronically.
Wow. Electronically.
Electronic.
That's funny. She could pick out her shit, and then the husband goes, no, 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 no. All right, I'll let you have this. Fuck you, fuck you.
Her console is like the little fake steering wheel that the kid pretends to drive.
Yes.
Not even
exactly,
hooked up.
Exactly, with a little fake rubber horn in the middle.
Give her a choice. You could either get breath mints or tampons.
Oh, damn, that's good.
Isn't that amazing? There's a little more.
1967, though.
67.
The future, 1967.
Sounds like it's from the 50s.
Yes.
Well, this is like the 50s or the...
This is the 40s.
40s, sure.
What the hell is this?
Apparently, music is not going to change at all.
Yes, it'll stay exactly the same.
Benny Goodman will still be a hit in the future.
Benny Goodman with his hit Umbrella, Ella, Ella, Ella.
This will be fantastic in the future. You can be at the office and look in on your wife at home, and we'll have a boxing glove on an accordion. And if you want to punch her in the face for not working, just press a button at work. There she goes. Down she goes. See her stagger to her feet. Now she's learned a lesson.
Rich from Manhattan, is this part of the Carousel of Time in Disney? Please update that effing ride.
Yeah.
What's the Carousel of Time? I don't remember.
That's at Disneyland. Spaceship Earth is the best.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Communication. It started with papyrus. You know, and they show all this stuff, and they're like present day one is 20 years old.
A typewriter.
Exactly. They show all this fiber optic stuff and these bloop, 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 bloop spacey noises.
Everything will be buttons of different colors that flash and don't, they're not even labeled.
It's wonderful, yes. Flashing lights, fiber optic, and tapes that go back and forth and back and forth for no apparent reason. Why is it still the 40s? Could at least put on some Jimi Hendrix. It was the 60s.
This is the go-to music, though.
Yes, right you are for this voice. What? And look around the neighborhood. You won't see any of them.
Yeah, staying in the past.
Yes. We're going to leave them here.
The future will be wonderful. Look around your neighborhood. Yes, your daughter Betsy can walk around in safety.
You have the iPhone. They have the rotary phone. Isn't the future great?
The future.
We have more audio from 1967.
A central bank computer will debit the family's account the amount of purchases and credit the department store for.
They were talking about online fucking banking in 1967?
Yeah, pretty much it.
Wow.
They just thought it was video, that's all. They thought it was like video cameras pointing at.
Yeah, you'd have to actually look at something live.
They thought
from
it was
a live
all video
feed.
Surveillance being integrated.
They couldn't figure out that you could do it a lot easier with just pictures.
Just capture a digital picture.
GIFs, they didn't know
about. Gonna be working
what
all,
is that?
What's going to be working
GIF
all these
GIF is a great
cameras.
Peanut butter.
Yeah.
That's all I know. Make a picture of it, you're talking silly.
Uh-oh, what happened? That's true.
Come on, I wanted to hear the rest of that.
Purchases and credit the department store, for example. Informing the family's home computer at the same time. Father, at the touch of a button, receives an instantaneous printed copy of his budget, the amount of taxes he owes, the payments left on the car, and so forth.
And what that pesky cunt spent on clothes.
I love the fact that just Dumbbell does some shopping while the man figures out the
plan. Guy's got to figure everything out while stupid's just pressing buttons because the pretty dresses were pretty colors.
Exactly.
My wife has an old magazine, a really old magazine, and there's an ad for some kind of silk sheets, like some designer sheets.
Yeah.
And the ad is a cartoon of a woman sitting in bed, a really fancily, and the point of the ad is, how are you going to explain to your husband that you bought this? That so he won't be mad. And they show a guy walking in the bedroom with a briefcase, and he looks really mad.
He looks pissed.
And she has this sheepish smile, and they give her point, like bullet points. Here's
how
the
about
things
a blowjob?
Here's the things to say to him so he won't beat you, basically. Like, these are cheaper than other brands. These will last a long time.
If you can get it out of your mouth before he cracks you in it.
Exactly. That's what it looks like.
Darker skinned men will slide off it. Yes. As opposed to being able to violate me.
And you know his breath just smells like fucking whiskey and martinis.
A cigarette.
He's all drunk.
15 drinks on the fucking Metro Line train.
A little observation. We're trying to find that, and so far we got how to turn a person in bed.
Be doing that.
All right.
Car, and so forth. All documents and household records are available on the video screen for immediate reference. Also at his disposal is an electronic correspondence machine, or home post office, which allows
email.
For instant written communication between individuals anywhere in the world.
That'll never happen.
Wow.
To maintain these and hundreds of complex electronic circuits, a monitor checks all circuits every few seconds, inserts a backup circuit if and when trouble develops, and alerts the communal service agency for replacement.
The music gets scary there.
Yeah, the server was like fucking up.
My mother's a computer programmer, and they installed a new machine called a Sun machine, like this really huge machine that they had to put their software on. So they put it in their office and plugged it in, and then 2 days later, there was a guy from UPS saying he had a part for the machine, and nobody ordered it.
Oh, shit.
And it turns out the machine ran a self-diagnosis.
Oh, my God.
Found a faulty part, got into their system, and ordered it through UPS.
Cyberdyne.
It summoned a piece to itself, paid for it out of their accounts.
It's everything. Becoming aware. It's becoming aware.
Fucking crazy.
Wow. That's
they
fucked up.
They unplugged it, and they're like, we're not...
The fucking machine's ordering shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow, that is too fucked up.
Fucking, whatever this, like, Everybody Loves Raymond box set.
Yeah, it starts ordering shit, they're like, no, I needed it.
Pizzas, you know. Coming to the door.
That's pretty cool.
It's really cool on the iPhone. So I can hear when we're on speaker.
Yeah.
But then when I go to talk without the speaker, just hold it up. It kind of goes mute.
How come I can hear?
Yeah, it's a good feature in the iPhone.
Oh,
yeah.
Jesus. He is gonna just throw that thing.
I will eventually break it.
Yeah, you
will. I will eventually break it. Yeah,
I'm in for 2 years on the fucking thing. I totally regret it.
The way I look at it is this. I have fucking told enough people exactly what this phone is. I've gotten my money back in a way.
Yeah.
I'm not going to hurt Apple, but you know what? If 500 less people in the entire two countries that are hearing this buy this fucking piece of shit rip-off phone, stick to the Mac computers.
I'm an Apple fanatic. I wanted this thing the instant I heard about it.
Yeah.
It's a piece of garbage. If you're the perfect consumer for the iPhone, you should not buy it.
Hey, that's cool and all, but
if your name is iPhone Haver,
yeah,
you should pass.
Hey, flingtoday.com.
Yeah.
Looking for a gay fling? Click here for guys in your area.
Mm.
And then it has set up your Fling Today profile right now. It's free. And then you got a lot of these. These are the actual broads that you can stop.
Yeah, sure.
Look to your right, Jimmy. Are these broads you think you get through flingtoday.com?
Oh, yeah. I bet you go on and they're lining right up. Sure.
You know a thing or two about a thing or two, right, Jimmy?
Sure do.
Are those the models?
Oh, yeah.
A little bait and switch action going on?
No. Those are the regular girls.
Those are the ones you get.
Sure, they're waiting to have a fling. And today.
Yeah. You could actually fuck the picture on your screen. And your dick will actually go in.
Hold on. Go to That's More Girls That Want to Fuck from New York.
Future.
Yeah.
Go down. More Girls That Want to Fuck from New York. Here we go. So Lisa Lusty One wants to fuck you today, right?
She wants to have a fling?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because she's just hanging around.
Yeah.
That's really what that video should have, that thing from 67 should have been. The future, you can come on the screen of the television that shows the big open pussy.
The working husband is jerking off to what is called internet pornography. On his computer unit,
fornicate.
While the wife cooks on hers.
Fornicate with a negress.
What's up, Jimmy? Jimmy's losing his mind over there.
There's nothing I hate more than being fucking stolen from.
What happened?
Who stole something?
What happened?
Hold on.
He's trying to circumnavigate something on his iPhone. I see him pressing some buttons.
There you go.
He is.
Hey, Jim, it's Lydia.
Who's Lydia?
Just took the speaker off. Where is the fucking volume? Where is it?
Where is it?
Lydia's my literary agent.
Wait, what happened?
Do you have your volume off or something?
No, we just heard it through speaker.
Yeah, but is there something?
When it goes off speaker. And I guess Steve Jobs is just so brilliant and so hip, he forgot that when you use a phone, you put it to your ear, and you hold the other end to your mouth, and you talk and listen.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to be wearing a black mock turtle for it to work.
Ah, like yes, and do the little zip. Everything opens. I really want to break it. I want to break it.
Is the case covering up maybe a sensor or
something? You
know something?
What? You might let me take the case.
Give that a whirl.
Here's a, let's see. Here's a, maybe I just don't know how to hit a volume thing.
Do
Here we go.
It. Do it.
No,
I won't.
Do
it.
There's no way I'll do it.
All right, take it off speaker. And then put the fucking ear part, not the mouth part.
But you'd hear it, dude. You'd hear it a little bit coming out.
Nothing.
Yeah.
So as soon as you take it off speaker, she goes away?
That's Everything broken.
Does. Of course it's broken.
That's busted.
Why wouldn't it be?
Your phone's busted.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
There's no way I'll break it.
No, he
as
can't
As much
break
as I would
it.
Love, the satisfaction of baseball batting it would be wonderful, but I just can't now. But I'm just going to go back to the closet.
So did you get your
$100? You robbed me for 2 years. You fucking robbed me for 2 years.
Did you get your $100
rebate
thing?
Oh, no, I went. The New York store doesn't have it. When the guy was blowing me off... I was trying to buy a fucking $6,000 worth of computer equipment. The guy was kind of a cunt to me.
Right.
Oh, boy. Whatever, man. I just fucking disgusted. I love... You got me so hooked on fucking Mac.
Yep. Well...
You didn't get your 100? Did you get your 100?
Haven't gotten
No, it. You're lazy. Same thing I did. I was at the Apple store. I went down to buy that big 30-inch monitor.
Mm-hmm.
And I go down there, and I was there and didn't get it.
Yep.
It was too, Well, it was too much of a hassle.
No, you could give me, like, if I got something in the mail that said, all you got to do is fill this out and take it to the post office,
then I'll
get $14 million, and I'd be like, ugh.
Oh, the post office. I have a stamp. I got, oh, fuck it. It would be sitting there until it expired.
Yeah. Right, right.
Sitting up on the counter.
Let's go to Scott. Scott, what's up?
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Hey, hey, Scott.
Hey, man.
I have a horror story with Verizon. I bought a like $600 Verizon phone, and I had insurance for it, and it died pretty much 3 months into owning it. And they replaced it, and they actually died yesterday. And still paying for insurance, I called up and said, look, I want to replace it. They said, nope, sorry, I can't replace your phone. So I basically told Verizon to go fuck off.
Yeah, but that, they don't care.
I bought the iPhone. No, they don't care. And
the whole, you know, go fuck yourself doesn't...
They don't care. Well, I'm going to take a baseball bat to it and put it up on YouTube. And
they don't feel it. They don't have any nerve endings in their phones.
Well, dude, you're right. Verizon can be scumbags, too. I'm certainly not saying that they can't be. Every phone company is shit. My problem is just this perception and the way that you get right, the black turtleneck and the way they zip through everything with their fingers and then for me not to be able to hear on it. If and the speaker volume is atrocious.
You know what the best thing is? We should just pop up the video from when they introduced it.
Yeah.
For Jimmy. And look at the picture and now look at what I'm doing with it.
Yeah, and the whole audience is just freaking out.
So stupid.
Dude, how about a phone call?
The real problem with it is not having tactile number buttons.
Yeah.
Is it means that you have to look at it like 40% more than you would. You don't realize how much you don't look at your phone when you're using it.
Yeah.
Because you feel the numbers under your thumb. You don't miss by a number because you're pressing a piece of smooth glass.
Piece of shit.
My friend Ken. Is it really that bad? I wrote back, I fucking hate it. And he goes, I was going to buy one. Thanks. You're welcome, Ken.
Oh, wow.
It's good.
There you go. One happy customer.
There it
is. Spread the word. It's a piece of shit.
Can I point out an interesting stat?
Yeah. Oh, statistics.
It's always fun. 7 o'clock is the stats hour. iPhone mystery, 1.4 million sold, 250,000, quarter million never activated.
A quarter million iPhones never activated.
And I don't know how that happened. Other than the fact that my girlfriend and I were having dinner the other night, and Brooke Shields was at the table behind me. Did I tell you this?
No.
And she was going to text me, because she didn't want to say it, because she was right behind us. So she's like, I'm texting you. And an hour and 20 minutes later, I got the text. Because apparently sitting across from someone, and finally she's like, did you get my text? I'm like, no. And then she had to mouth, Brooke Shields is behind you. And I went, where's Brooke Shields?
Did you have a signal?
Yes.
You got an hour and a half later?
Yeah, well, I figured out the reason, the way it works with AT&T is that when you send a text, somebody jots it down and runs it to a messenger service down the street, and then they retext it. That's what happened.
Oh, okay.
That is really frustrating.
With AT&T,
when
it really is.
You're 3 feet away from the person that is texting you, and you get an hour and a half later.
I actually caught myself biting my phone.
Yeah. Did you bite it?
When I put it through the case, I went, ha ha.
You like to bite things.
It's the only way I can express.
You're a biter.
Yes, I am.
The iPod thing with the quarter million, not activated? Presents. That people just didn't want.
That's a good point, too.
Oh, wow, yeah,
as a birthday gift or an anniversary gift, and you're like...
People waiting for their old contracts.
But I like my phone, or waiting for their contracts then.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. And also people that were buying them to sell on eBay.
Right. Yeah, because everyone thought they had a perfect scam. Oh, the UK man, who made 15,000 calls to women asking them about their underwear. He's going to jail for 2 years.
Two years for that?
This guy's great.
What's the charge? Like harassment or something?
Well, the underwear-obsessed telephone stalker's undoing proved to be the opening of a gym opposite the apartment that the 40-year-old shared with his mother. Detectives caught Paul Kavanaugh, on film, leaning over the balcony of the West London apartment just as he was peppering the gym's female receptionist with calls. Jailed for 2.5 years Friday, Kavanaugh admitted making some 15,000 such harassing calls to women, asking them questions about their underwear. He posed as a clothing researcher and claimed to be gathering marketing data for a retailer.
Ah, he had a story. Good.
He'd been making the calls for 12 years, usually starting off his conversations with seemingly innocuous questions about the women's socks and cardigans. Then he would move on to their underwear, making lewd suggestions to his victims.
How do people just not hang up and not bother with it?
I'm going to jail. What a creep. 15,000 calls.
Yeah, he's persistent. But I mean, it's... I
hope he's a good calling plan. Your friends, family, and frequently harassed program.
I don't know. How, on average, is your bill a lot more or a lot less than you thought it would be when you signed up for your iPhone?
It's, I believe, a little bit more. Not a lot, but I don't do that stupid email thing, but it's a little bit
more. Mine seems a lot more.
Yeah, I thought it was AT&T.
A lot more.
Really?
Yeah, I got a plan. They remember they said, like, there's the two plans or something?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. One was for something, and then $100 a month for another plan. So I got that one, figuring that was, like, good. And I read through everything, and it seemed pretty inclusive. But every month, I'm getting a phone bill that is over $200.
But why?
I don't know.
These stupid surcharge, a usage charge?
Dude, the charges on these bills have usage charge, tax on the usage charge, equipment charges, taxes on that, and then there's excise tax and a tax for a tax. They tax the crap out of everything.
They tax the crap out of tax.
Yes, they're taxing taxes.
How about Elliot Spitzer, Governor Spitzer, something about that and the way they are raping the public.
Ugh.
Instead of worrying about if a radio guy is going to see Van Halen at the Garden, how about
where he got his tickets from?
Well, you got to explain. Yeah, they really messed up radio, and every ticket has to be accounted for now if you work at a radio station. That's what Jimmy's... Because I asked for Foo Fighter tickets. I wasn't allowed to have Foo Fighter tickets because then Elliot Spitzer's office would be suspicious that some kind of plug-ola thing's going on.
How about Elliot Spitzer and then do something about these disgusting charges these thieves in the phone companies are putting on you? And they're thieves.
Because we talk about politicians all the time. That's tough stuff to do. It's easy to go after the soft subjects and soft topics out there. That would be pretty intense.
That'd be huge.
If you went after the phone company and said, what the F are you doing with all these extra charges every month?
Isn't that something that people could kind of get behind? You know?
Of course.
That's not like one of these stupid things that some people get behind, most people don't care about. That's something that people go, yeah, you know something? This would cut down on my cell phone bill. But no, they never go after that.
What is a usage charge? That's my phone bill.
That's my phone bill. I'm using the phone. There, I pay it.
Yeah, I don't think
they're pigs.
I don't think your cable bill should be up to $200 a month either. What is that about?
Well, there's no hidden charges in that, I don't think. Like, at least, I
haven't seen any. When I get a huge cable bill, I look and it's, you know, I get all the channels and movies and stuff like that. Oh, I think it's way too expensive.
It's way too expensive.
But,
ridiculous.
They pretty much got you by the right there.
Yeah.
But the phone thing is this, you read through your phone bill, you have no clue what those charges are. And there's no explanation for them. And then I don't even understand why it's so much for the iPhone above what my plan was for. My plan is for $100. And it was supposedly unlimited data and a transfer. And then I'm looking and I'm paying a hell of a lot more. And I don't understand why.
AT&T, I hope Apple understands that AT&T has been an abysmal failure as a carrier. They have been an abomination as far as a carrier. Mm-hmm. You understand, you get a photo texted to you, a photo sent to you. It's like when I had I had Verizon, and the way it would work with Verizon is I still couldn't get photos from my BlackBerry. So I would have to go to the site, but you have an account, and you could save all the photos you have in your account. You sign in, and there's the photo. It's a little inconvenient, but it was doable. This stupid AT&T, you get a text. It has a different code password and code number for every photo
time
you get.
You get a photo.
It opens in a small window. You can't save it to anything. It is despicably bad technology.
Look at it full size. You got to look at it in this postage stamp little size. It really is ridiculous.
AT&T is horrendous.
Well,
horrendous carrier.
We got Greg on Long Island talking about AT&T. Greg, what's up?
Yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know that when you go into a dealer to sign up for AT&T, AT&T basically, in one way or another, forces the dealers to put add-ons that you don't know about, add-ons such as towing, things like insurance.
Towing? What?
hold on, towing.
Wait, did you say towing?
Yes, I did, like towing your car if you are to become disabled. they add stuff like that onto your bill. I was speaking with a gentleman yesterday.
I am completely lost about the towing.
Towing?
Thing. What are you talking about?
Is there like a tow hotline for AT&T customers?
Like insurance, like AA, AAA, whatever that thing is.
Right.
They have that for your cell phone so that you're insured through AT&T.
Oh, okay.
Oh, like the GPS thing.
Right.
It tells where you are.
They add on to your bill that you don't normally look at or wouldn't even realize. A lot of times it's putting in item code. So you don't know what this code is and what you're being charged for. There's one guy that I was talking to said that he had the three separate instances where people came in and their kids had that insurance on their phone and they were only 12, 13 years old, so they weren't even driving, yet they were paying a monthly fee to have that insurance.
You know what AT&T should put their resources into? Putting some towers on the west side of Manhattan so calls are not constantly dropped. How about that? How about that is where they put their efforts?
A lot of times what happens is people don't want the towers by them. And they go out and fight and lobby to not have the towers put by their houses. And usually it's the people that use their cell phones that are complaining.
Well, how does Verizon and Sprint do it?
I don't know. It's
two different types of technologies on how they actually operate. And what happens is, depending on who has the phones where, how many people are congested in one single area is what's going to determine how many people can talk and how clear it will be and whether or not you're going to get through. So if AT&T has too many customers, let's say, on Long Island that their system can't handle it, Verizon may not have as much, therefore their service is going to appear better.
Well, Verizon, here's the thing. I think they're the biggest, so they have the most everywhere. They have the best coverage, and I'm not shilling for Verizon. I mean, their customer service is as awful as anybody's.
Yeah.
But AT&T service has been such a disgusting disappointment.
All right, let's go to Roland in Tennessee. Roland?
Hey, what's up, guys?
You have this towing thing, this towing charge?
Yeah, I got Sprint service, and if you run out of gas right now, you just call it, and they'll come out and give you some gas to get you to the station, or they'll come out and tow you to a shop.
Do most people know they have this? Or
But is it on everyone's bill?
No, I had to select it. I went to the store and looked at the sheet, and said, okay, I wanted that towing package on it.
All right, that guy's claiming they just throw that on without you even knowing about it.
And maybe they do.
And you'll never use the service because you had no clue you had it. All right, thank you, sir. Let's go to Mike in Westchester. Mike, what's up?
What's up, bro? How you doing?
Hey.
Dude, listen, I bought the iPhone when it first came out, right? The
yes.
first billing cycle, I had a $3,100 bill.
Why?
Dude, I don't know. I had a $3,100 bill. I started getting all these recalls on the phone and everything else. I called up AT&T, and I had Tourette's syndrome. I was cursing everybody out.
What yeah, I got a huge bill when I went to the Bahamas for roaming charges. I understood it was going to be a little more than usual. I'd taken phones down there. I'd had it on roaming, and you know you pay extra for that. But
you
it was so ridiculous. It was something like $1,200 I had to pay in a phone bill, which I've never paid that much in a phone
you
bill.
You said something interesting there. You knew it would be a little more. Most people have no idea. You go out of country, and all of a sudden your phone is just on, and it's roaming. It's
when it says
off.
Roaming, it doesn't just mean, hey, I'm just going to roam around. You stay here. I'm going to hit the beach and the bars.
Right, right.
You go out. It's not just roaming. It's costing you extra money.
They're getting, the phone companies are just getting away with murder.
Huh? I wasn't even out of the country, bro.
Why was it so much?
I don't know. What happened was I called up, and they said to me I was in roaming. I drive a truck. I live and work in Westchester County. The farthest trip I go to is Dutchess County. So they turned around and told me I have a $3,100 bill.
Must be one dead area that you're roaming in that you keep going through.
Just disgusting, man. They're thieves.
It's sick. It's sick. It's crazy. And the funny thing about it is I think the president who owns or who works for AT&T got raped by monks with hoods on their head. They're raping all the people with phones.
Okay, I didn't quite get your point about the monks
check,
with hoods
how do
on their
you
head.
Check your bill on the iPhone.
Let's go to Brian in Pennsylvania. Brian, what's up?
Hey, good morning,
check
guys.
Our bills.
Hey.
Hey.
A little bit off subject, but I have a late nomination for
line of the day within the past hour. You guys were talking about the birthday and the prince and everything, and you guys blew right past Anthony's line when he said, I can see if it's a landmark birthday, 21, sweet 16, and then he goes, 9.
Yes, I did. That's okay. Oh, no, did you just check your bill?
No.
What's wrong?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, usage. Let's see.
Just check the usage.
Oh, Jesus, of course he is. Well, then how about helping us out?
Wait, what happened?
Exactly. What happened?
Here it is.
I don't know how to...
Oh, well.
There you go.
Of course.
Matt in California, what's up?
What's up, boy?
Hey.
Hey, I was just calling. A caller earlier said... Talking about insurance on your phone bill and said something about a 13-year-old that wasn't even driving. It's not car insurance. It's insurance on your phone. If you break it, you call them and they send you a new one.
I know, but I think they send you a used one. All the phone companies have that, and you'll get a refurbished. That's the word they'll use. Refurbished.
Refurbished. That's used.
Like it's furbished again. I've never gotten anything furbished. I don't know what it means.
I just wanted furbished.
Can I have a furbished phone? No, don't furbish it again. How do you furbish something?
I don't know. All right, hey, Tim put this together from earlier.
Anthony Cumia's seminar for a greener planet. I completely believe in global warming now, and we have to do something about this because we're doomed.
Recycle.
Join Anthony in his fight for a cleaner world.
A second ice age coming if we don't watch out.
Anthony Cumia's seminar for a greener planet.
The ice caps are melting, Opie. The ice caps. 10 years, Europe can be frozen. Armageddon is right around the corner in your lifetime.
Make the world a better tomorrow for your children and your children's children.
I'd say by the day after tomorrow. Tomorrow, we're pretty much done.
The Anthony Cumia Seminar for a Greener Planet on the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the end of the world. I was taken out of context.
No, you weren't. That's what you said.
I was taken out of context. Some of those words were indeed mine.
No, you're now officially an environmentalist.
But for the most part, I'm an environmentalist. Yeah, that, oof, that'll be the day.
It says it right there.
I am not.
It says it right there. Let's go to CJ in New York. What's up, CJ?
Yeah, what's going on, man?
Hey.
I got a quick question for you, man. I listen to you guys every fucking morning. You guys are hilarious.
Hold on, you're cursing, sir. That didn't go out over the radio.
Yeah, we want a lot of people to hear what you're saying, so try not to curse too much, okay?
Not a problem.
All right, go ahead, CJ.
Guys, every morning, you guys are hilarious. I caught Jimmy Norton's Monster Rain on HBO. That guy, I don't know, he had me falling over, you know?
Thank you.
But everybody's whining and moaning about these cell phone charges, but you get these people that run around and all they do is talk on their damn cell phone all the time.
We're not complaining about being charged to use the phone. And this is not just AT&T. Every company does it. I had it with Verizon, too. There's these, and now we talk about hidden charges. They find reasons just to continually raping you. They can't just be square with you as a consumer.
Oh, they anally violate you every time you turn around. They get you coming and they get you going. But you need the service. You want the service. It's a convenience factor, you know, because nobody can use their home phone.
Yes, you're right. Again, I'm not complaining about the service. What I'm complaining about is when they put on charges like a usage charge and a tax and this and that and this that you're not supposed to have to pay. That's my complaint.
They tax you on the tax. Yes, you get they tax you on your tax that they charge you on your damn phone, you know? They owe all the taxes $11.27. Well, you got to tack on another 70 cents because you $11.27 equals 70 cents in tax. But it seems to me Governor Pataki, he don't care about that. He has no stake in that. It's the gas prices that he cares about.
Governor Pataki.
CJ,
I'm calling from another time. This is fascinating.
CJ, when are you going to get to you wanted to say who gives a s? Gas prices are worse.
That's right. Gas need to be adjusted.
Yes, they do, but they're not mutually exclusive.
Yeah, maybe we could just adjust them. Okay, $10 a barrel.
You can do both of these things. You don't have to make a decision. Gas or cell phones, folks. It's up to you. Why?
Pick and choose. If you were on a desert island. Here it is. My current balance. Last payment received, $215. Current balance, and this, I'm not even closed yet, $200.39.
For what?
This is over $400 for 2 months of service. Dude, I don't know. I don't know. I have to call and ask questions. But calling is a pain in the ass, too.
Any type of customer service you got to deal with.
They got it all figured out. You have to call to find out the answers, but we all know that's just
no one calls.
Nightmare, so yeah. Just continue. You know that I still pay for AOL. I haven't checked it in 2 to 3 years because I know it's going to be a pain in the ass.
That's what I did.
To call them and just cancel the dumb thing.
Dude, 7 years. 7 years I had AOL and I never used it. Two accounts. Just get boom, boom, every month. And then finally I'm going through my bill. I said, you know, I'm going to call them and cancel. It took hours to cancel. And I got one of those guys that was just wouldn't let you cancel. Well, look, we'll leave you signed up. We'll cancel the account, but you still have like 6 months free. And I go, no, I don't. Just cancel it. Completely cancel it right now. You do understand we have these offers that. Holy Jesus, just cancel the goddamn service.
I joined a gym recently, a new gym, and they're going to take, you know, my fee out monthly from my credit card. And I'm like, oh, you're doing that because you're going to get so many people that are going to like pay for 2, 3, 4, 5 a year before they go, wait a minute, I'm still paying for the gym membership and I don't go there anymore. And then they finally cancel. I'm like, this is a wonderful revenue stream for you guys. You know, if you take money out of someone's credit card month after month, that you're going to get a lot of people that aren't going to be paying too much attention. They're going to be paying for something they're not using anymore. He goes, yeah, you're absolutely right, but, you know, it's corporate policy, and what can I tell you? I just work here, but you know what?
Yeah.
Between me and you, you're absolutely right. That's why they do these things. They figured out little revenue, you know, streams. They know the percentage of people, they probably do their research, that will not cancel a service right away and will allow a company to continue taking out charges from their credit card before they finally wake up and go, wait a minute here.
Yeah.
Just a scam. Because they try to make it sound like it's easier for you that we just take your fee out monthly. Yes, there, Jimmy.
Current balance. Hold on. $169.73. And I'm supposed to have the $100 plan too, right?
Yeah. So where is this extra money going from?
I don't.
Shouldn't a $100 plan mean
be $100?
I hate that crap.
Like any time I sign up for a phone and I have like a plan, you know, whether it was $39, $49, $59, whatever it is, that was my bill. So I really never went over anything. I always signed up for the whatever I could unlimited, whether it's data transfer or whatever.
Yeah.
And I'm noticing that I'm paying twice what I'm supposed to be paying, at least.
Is it $100? Now, I saw a $40 thing, too. Is it $100 for unlimited phone and then $40 for additional unlimited data? Maybe that's the thing, like with texting.
I don't know.
I want somebody who knows this.
Gotta read your contract.
Can someone print out a contract?
Read your contract.
Can someone print out an AT&T contract?
Where is it?
Good luck.
Good luck.
Another one.
Exactly.
I went and got a camera recently. And they had a special or whatever, and they said, I don't remember exactly, but just follow me, you'll understand. It was like, let's say $499. I'm like, ooh, $499, perfect.
Great.
Plus tax, warranty, then we got this guard thing, and then we do this, and then we get, you know, for an extra $20, we'll give you this and this, and then, and all of a sudden, they just threw so many charges at me. I'm like, that camera that is like advertised $499, I'm walking out like $700.
Yeah.
I'm like, what happened to the $499
camera?
Doesn't exist. I would love a company to go, look, here it is. This camera right here is going to cost you exactly this. We ain't going to mess with you.
Yeah.
First of all, make it prices $499 because $499 sounds like you're paying, you know, in the 400s for a camera. No,
right.
It's $500.
It's $500.
But it looks
right
better
to see.
It looks better to see four instead of five when you're trying to save a little money.
They do that to you every time. And I never take any of the extended warranty things.
Never.
That's betting. You're placing a bet that what you just bought is going to break. You're hoping it breaks so you can get your dollars worth out of that plan.
And I think they'll give you a refurbished one anyway. They won't give you a new one.
All right. Refurbished.
I'd like one that has been furbished again, please.
Furbished.
Here you are.
Can you...
What is to furb something?
I don't know.
This is furbished.
Can you move that out of the way? Thank you, E-Rock. Jesus Christ. Why would you put up the iPhone terms and conditions and then, like, decide you need to instant message someone over the thing?
Because he's E-Rock.
Just move it to the side, and then you could do both things at one time. Let's see. Cell phone company imposes monthly regulatory cost recovery charge of up to $125 to help defray costs incurred in complying with state and federal telecom regulations, state and federal universal service charges, and surcharges for customer-based and revenue-based state and local assessments on AT&T. These are not taxes or government-required charges. International messages not included. Charges for international messages sent from the U.S. are 25 cents for text messages and 50 cents for picture/video messages. Additional charges for premium messages and content apply. Messages over 300 KBs billed and additional 50 cents per message. Terms applicable.
Thank you for clearing that up.
You jumped over something.
What?
It said not, these are not government charges or taxes.
Yeah.
So what exactly are they?
Well, this is how this is how they get you. You're like, this is like trying to like read a foreign language. Terms applicable to Nation Family Talks GSM plans. Credit approval required. Subscribers must live and have a mailing address within AT&T's own network coverage area. An early termination fee of $175 applies if service is terminated before the end of the contract term. If phone is returned within 3 days, activation fee will be refunded. If phone is returned within 14 days in like new condition with all components, early termination fee will be waived. Service may be canceled after 14 days, but within 30 days, an early termination fee will be waived, but equipment may not be returned. All other charges apply. 30? Some dealers impose additional fees. Minute increment billing and usage. Airtime and other measured usage are billed in full minute increments, and actual airtime and usage are rounded up to the next full increment at the end of each call
about
for billing purposes.
Days?
Charges a full phone company charges a full minute increment of usage for every fraction of the last minute used to each on each wireless call. I mean, some of this you pick up, but most of this is like your brain starts to explode. Minutes will be depleted according to usage in the following order. Night and weekend minutes, mobile-to-mobile minutes, anytime minutes, and rollover minutes. Calls placed on networks served by other carriers may take longer to be processed, and billing for these calls may be delayed. Those minutes will be applied again against your anytime monthly minutes in the month in which the calls appear on your bill. Unanswered outgoing calls for 30 seconds or longer incur airtime. You may obtain usage information by calling customer service or using one of our automated systems. Pricing, taxes, no proration. Final month's charges are not prorated.
But prices why is my bill $200?
I'm getting to it. Prices are subject to change. Prices do not include taxes. Activation fees, $36 activation fee for each new line. $26 activation fee applies on each additional family talk line. Nights and weekends. Nights are 9 p.m. to 6 a.m. Weekends are 9 p.m. Friday to 6 a.m. Monday based on time of day and switch providing your service, including long-distance calls can be made from the 50... Oh my God, I have to go all the way down to here? This is like 20 pages. Calls can be made from the 50 United States, Puerto Rico, and U.S. Virgin Islands to the 50 United States, Puerto Rico, U.S. Virgin Islands, Guam, and Northern Mariana
Islands. That's terrible,
Islands.
I'm sorry.
Roaming charges do not apply when roaming within the service area of land-based networks of the 50 United States, Puerto Rico, and U.S. Virgin Islands. International long-distance rates vary. Additional charges apply to services used outside the land borders of the U.S., Puerto Rico, and U.S. Virgin Islands. Unlimited voice services. Unlimited voice services are provided solely for live dialogue between two individuals. Unlimited voice services may not be used for conferencing, calling, call forwarding, monitoring services, data transmissions, transmissions of broadcasts, transmission of recorded material, or other connections which do not consist of uninterrupted live dialogue between two individuals. If A&T finds that you are using an unlimited voice service offering for other than live...
Turn it off.
...for other than live dialogue between two individuals,
turn it off.
The company may, at its option, terminate your service or charge your plan to one with no unlimited usage comments. Phone company will provide notice that it intends to take any of the above actions, and you may terminate the agreement. International roaming. Substantial charges may be incurred if phone is taken out of the U.S., even if those services are intentionally used. Off-net usage. If your minutes of use, including unlimited services on other carrier networks, off-net usage during any two consecutive months exceed your off-net usage allowance.
Shut up.
Phone company may, at its option, terminate your service, deny your continued use of other carrier covers, or change your plan to one imposing usage charge. For off-net usage, your off-net usage allowance is equal to the lesser of 750 minutes or 30% of the anytime minutes included with your plan. Phone company will provide notice if it intends to take any of the above actions, and you may terminate the agreement. Oh, caller ID blocking. Your billing name may be displayed along with your wireless numbers on outbound calls to other wireless and landline phones. With caller ID capability, contact customer service for that information. I'm blocking the display of your name. You may be charged for both an incoming and an outgoing call when incoming calls
Can you dig that?
Or route it to voicemail even if no message is left. See wireless service agreement for additional conditions and restrictions. Family talk. Who the F, dude?
No, no, no!
This is him. Okay?
E-Rock.
We didn't even get into rollover minutes, mobile-to-mobile minutes, term application to features, voice dials, wireless data service terms and conditions, general terms and conditions applicable to the phone company data service, including but not limited features that may be used with data service and wireless content.
I just wanted to know why.
But keep going, keep going. Look at how long this thing is.
They do this on purpose.
Look, yeah, it's a, that's they, what I'm getting at.
No one's going to read it.
Eh, who cares? They know. That, to me, if you unravel this, you can probably have charges knocked off, but they know that you're not going to because it's only a few bucks a month. But do that, you know, times 5 million customers, and you make a lot of money.
See, I'm just going to have to call and ask. Wait.
Mm. Go to the top of this. I know this is a visual, but maybe we'll try to. I mean, okay, all the way to the top. Okay, we're on the internet. Watch this scroll by. Who the F is going to read this and understand? Like a part
it's
of that
teeny tiny text.
That keep, it's keep going.
Still scrolling.
E-Rock's been scrolling the whole time.
Still scrolling. Keeps,
yep.
It's scrolling, like a mortgage.
Scrolling. Yeah. It would honestly, it would probably take me a minimum of a half hour to read this whole thing at fast speed on the radio. A minimum.
Can we have
probably longer.
A word count. Do you know you can put that in a Word document? I'd love to see how many words that contract is.
Well, look at the bottom of this thing. Pulled. Hold on. Go to the bottom. Go to the bottom again. A little further up. I just saw something. Pooled data connect plans.
Hmm. That might be it.
And then they talk about additional kilobyte charge.
Ah, see, that's the problem. Additional kilobyte charge.
Do you know what a CRU is?
Yeah, I do.
That's right.
What's a CRU?
It's married to one. Okay. I don't know, but I know what that first word is.
All right, there you go. Foundation account. Do you know what a foundation account is?
Sure.
You do. What is it, Jimmy?
That's when the foundation decides that they need to make calls, they get an account.
Yeah.
All right.
Of course, the account that. Upon which other accounts are built.
Well, let's not forget, guys. CRU. Here, go to this down here.
Upon which.
Don't forget, too, by the way, CRUs on pool plans and CRUs participating in a legacy pool data connect plan pool created prior to February 17, 2006. Legacy pool cannot be in the same pool, but can be within the same fan.
That's to do with pools.
And users on non-pooling plans may be included in the same fan as CRUs on pool plans. However, these non-pooling end users will not receive the pooling benefits or contribute included usage to a pool.
I don't know what that even means.
I rest my case, Judge.
People are asking, is the pool heated?
6,000.
Really?
707 words.
How many pages did that come out to?
11.
11 pages?
6,000 word contract.
And you're supposed to sit there at the phone store while you're waiting to get a phone. Read that first. Wait a minute. Can I have my lawyer go over this paragraph with you?
I want to know, and Ope, you read this, and the first
I did?
Paragraph,
I don't even know what I read.
And I don't think this is exclusive to AT&T. It's the one thing here. AT&T, and again, this may be Verizon and all of them, also imposes a monthly regulatory cost recovery charge up to $1.25 to help defray. What does defray mean exactly?
It's like defer, only fraying.
Defray means recapture costs incurred in complying with state and federal telecom regulations, state and federal universal service charges, and surcharge for customer-based and revenue-based state and local assessments onto AT&T. Like, they're just...
So like in other words, it's like we have to pay this, but we don't want to. So you're paying it. That's pretty much what that means. I would love to do that. Look, I'm gonna have to charge you more because I got like bills to pay.
Well, yes, Jimmy.
Can I tell you what a fine company Apple is?
Apple.
I was in San Francisco, and you know I was having problems with my iPhone. It was for a long time though. I don't know. I didn't drop it. I promise. But I wasn't able to hear when I picked it up until I had my Bluetooth in. So I go in San Francisco, but yeah, maybe you guys could look at this. And it was so cute that they said, well, the store's busy, because I'm used to being here in New York where the store is truly busy. You know, San Francisco's was, you know, there's 50 people. I laughed at them.
Yeah.
And the guy looked at it. He's like, yeah, there's something with it. All right, we'll get you a new one.
Really?
He takes me, looks at my ID, makes sure that I'm legit. And within a half hour, I got a brand new phone. He just handed it to me.
And it was all, did they transfer all the info?
No, well, I had gone back to the hotel across the room.
Oh, so you just synced
back up? They probably would have, yeah, but I didn't ask him to. But I did it myself. That easy. No crap, no paperwork, just the show ID, make
sure.
Isn't
that great?
Anyone else getting... I was trying to... Apple is just... wow.
Sweetie, what's the matter?
How am I trying to say this? Are you getting the impression that Apple's kind of changing the way businesses do business?
Yeah. I mean, they're...
They're way better at customer service than pretty much everybody, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you get that personal touch with Apple. When was the last time you felt that personal touch with a company or a product? It seems like Apple's really changing things around a little bit, and people are starting to follow their lead.
The guy at the front of the store, when I walked in and told him I had a problem, I'm like, yeah, I got something on my iPhone. He's like, what's the matter? I just said, like, well, I'm having problems hearing it. He goes, well, did you check your setting? This is the guy at the front to show you people, like, when you walk in. So he's like, let me see your phone. So he looks at it, he goes into general settings, and he's poking around, and he goes, all right, well, you might want to take it upstairs, because he couldn't figure out what it... But the guy tried to help me in the front of the store.
Did he say, I delete some of these before you give this phone back to me, or the police may be involved?
Yeah, well, he said something about, are you a substitute teacher? I'm like, let it go. No, but I did have to give my my phone over, and I forgot that there's a picture that I had actually taken of my genitals, I put it under the name Anthony Cumia.
So hey!
I told Ant one day, I'm like, Ant, call me. And he called me, and I held the phone up. And it was just, let's just say, just a lovely phone-filling photo.
Yes.
And I forgot that was on there.
That was still in there?
Yeah.
Thanks.
That's not your name attached to anymore.
That would be great to do. Instead of everyone, you know, taking a picture, so when that person calls, you see their face. It's like, you make everyone take your phone and take a picture of their junk. So every time the phone rings, and you can even go with your friend, Patrice O'Neill's calling me.
It's a little embarrassing. Well,
black, but smaller than you'd expect. Patrice, how are you?
No, you could do. You could use some of that MySpace voodoo. See, once
from the take a certain angle.
I make your unit look
lighting.
Well, I got to make
lighting and shading and makeup.
I did do that. It's all from, if you take a photo. If you take a photo of your junk, if you're standing up and you're aiming down, that puts everything in the foreground. Like it just looks like there's this massive mountain object, and everything else is tiny in comparison.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I did. And boy, it looks lovely.
And it's on your phone.
Of course, as it should be. What am I going to do? Put it in somewhere else?
Why?
What am I, a goose? What's the matter with you? Is it on my phone? Is it on my phone? Here you go. Ant, take a look.
Oh, God, Jimmy.
I've seen it live.
I've seen it live.
Yeah.
The only part that wrecks it, though, is that it's not just the junk. Yeah, there's a little more there sticking out, so it just kind of looks silly. It looks like
silly.
Looks like I'm strangling myself. God damn it, where's my... This fucking iPhone! You enter your info into it, and then it doesn't save your phone numbers.
No, what man, it's too early. How do you feel about that right now? About your iPhone?
It bugs me because it won't save the numbers.
And it's not big enough, and it's too fucking expensive.
Cock!
I like it, except for the fact that you can't text or receive pictures. That bugs the
piss out of me. You can't search your numbers.
You can't search the numbers.
My guy's name is Mark something, and I fucking put him in here, and he's not in here. For some time, you enter fucking stuff in here, and it doesn't stay.
Oh, I've never had that problem.
It drives me fucking nuts.
And a phone you could buy 10 years ago, you could totally fucking do that.
Oh, dude, it drives me fucking crazy.
But the iPhone is all the rage.
I do like the text. I do like the text... I could text faster than ever,
so
which is good.
I have giant, I don't know if you can see this,
wow,
but I have giant chubby fucking thumbs.
Yeah.
So that's my problem. I thought,
what's in the water in Canada, man?
Wow.
I wouldn't be able to use the iPhone.
Now we know why you're singing and not playing guitar.
I do usually just with my pointer finger.
So
and
you,
I just ting, 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 ting,
you're
ting,
like a one-button text
yeah,
guy.
Yeah, but pretty fast.
Really?
Like, I could text really
take
fast.
Take a look at that, though. Look at that thumb.
Wow!
Yeah.
What's going on?
It's my birth defect.
I see. Okay.
I'm embarrassed.
Yes.
His job before radio was he would poke pit bulls in the nose. That's all I could come up with.
He played Radar O'Reilly in MASH.
Radar O'Reilly.
Hide that thing.
This thumb decided to stop growing, so it gave me half a nail.
Wow, yeah, that's... I kind of want to see it again, really.
All right, here. Look,
wow.
And I grow the nail a little longer so you can't tell.
Aw.
Wow. That was a fun walkover. Yuck.
It's a little yucky out here in New York. Yucky.
It's that
wet snow. I like it. I'm in a good mood.
Oh.
What happened, Jimmy? What happened?
Ding, 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 ding. What?
God, no, Reason just had a critical phone call drop of the day. So on my way back, I stopped off at Verizon.
Oh, you did.
And there's a little BlackBerry that will have Verizon reception. And now I can use that. I can take pictures and I can text them. And I'm fucking going to keep my number now. But I'm so happy.
You're getting rid of your iPhone?
No, I'm going to keep it and keep my number because the AT&T reception has gotten slightly better.
Yeah.
But the inconsistency of it is mind-bending. And when that call got dropped, hello, hello.
Wait, you're not really explaining, though. You had a really important call.
Yeah, on a Friday afternoon. And I talked to the I talked them in the cab, and they're like, all right, I'll call you back in 10 minutes. So I walk into my apartment, and I hear hello. I'm like, hello, hello, hello.
Oh, oh.
And I looked at the fucking phone. It went boop, boop.
Yeah,
which
that
meant
little
call dropped.
I hate that sound.
And I hear it every time I use the phone in my apartment because it's, you know, it's somewhere in Beirut. Oh, sorry, that's the west side of Manhattan. Sorry.
Not many people live there, though.
And, you know, fucking didn't work again, man. I can't tell you the anger I felt when that got dropped. I mean, like Verizon, there's places like on 6th Avenue, my calls always get dropped. There's certain places that are dead zones for cell.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But Verizon just, look, I have no interest in Verizon at all. They get coverage fucking everywhere. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
They do.
So you got a BlackBerry now?
No, I didn't have time. I wanted, if there was another comedian in just hanging all this, you wouldn't have fucking seen old Jimmy Norton until 9:30. I would have been known as the BlackBerry kid.
I need to get my BlackBerry.
Is that a BlackBerry there?
Yeah.
I'm getting pretty much the same one.
Yeah, but it's really tough to do email on this with the double tap.
Oh, I never use email. I don't email.
Oh, then you'll be fine.
What about textuses?
I'll take the double-click texting. It's a little more annoying. Like, the iPhone had a really good text system.
Love the iPhone's text.
I'll take that and know that I'm not going to get a fucking error message every time I try and text.
Mm.
Or I'm not going to get a call dropped. You know what? I'll take the important call, and I'll be the fucking double-click kid. And I'll take a photo of my cock, and I'll text it to whoever wants one. Here's a cock photo. Ka-ching. You can't do that with certain phones.
No, you can't. No. That's upsetting. I don't like the fact that you can't text a photo with the iPhone.
Nah,
figure that out.
They have it. They have it figured out.
Of course they
just
do.
Didn't do it on purpose.
Next generation.
And I wait for you.
Ooh.
With or without you.
Oh, he's crooning.
With or without you.
I just want these songs to start.
Yeah.
When is this song going to start?
I never do.
Why?
Maybe when AT&T brings me online. Maybe.
Oh, boy.
What happened, Jimmy? Nothing what happened? Happened? You were in a good mood.
Yeah, just trying to check something online, and once again, AT&T.
Trying to check online on your phone, your iPhone.
You like your iPhone.
I do. I just hate AT&T. The iPhone itself is an amazing piece of technology.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you can see them actually now if you go to myspace.com/JimNorton and get a friend request.
Jimmy.
Me.
Really?
No, yes. You can.
Yes, you can.
When are you going to switch over to Facebook?
Fuck Facebook. You're going to have 5,000 friends. What am I going to do? Send out a blast of 5,000 people and play fucking Scrabulous?
Yeah, but
Facebook can eat my bag.
But if you're going to have friends, you should have it
Scrabulous.
With a number you could handle.
No, that's to promote and to let fans know what you're doing, since my website sucks a dick.
It does? I thought you liked
it. It fucking sucks a dick.
I thought you liked your website.
What happened?
Well, the guy, Chris, did a good update on me. I was happy with it. I still don't like the calendar page, but he didn't do that.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to go to another company. I fucking hate dealing with the company I'm dealing with. They're very slow. Everything takes a fucking 6 months to get fixed. It's just irritating me.
All right already.
You're right.
No, I was doing Jim Norton.
Oh.
That's my new thing.
Nah, but I need to get,
You just need to get a new webmaster.
I want fucking web people. I want a good website.
Do you like AT&T? Now that we're not over there?
Did you? I would say it over there. AT&T.
You kind of said it over there, but you were cursing, so they dumped out.
Fucking sucks a dick.
You're not happy with AT&T iPhone.
I like the iPhone. The iPhone is a brilliant piece of technology. But the fact that they stuck a big Steve Jobs dick in our ass when it came to the server. It's like, come on, guys, what are you doing?
That sucks, and the fact that you can't get a fucking picture texted to you, it makes you go to the View My Picture.
ViewMyMessage.com,
where you got to go there, and for some reason, you can't go there on the iPhone.
Right.
So you got to go to your computer at home and go there. And look at a postage stamp size picture that somebody sent you. That sucks dick.
It's the fucking worst thing I've ever seen in my life. Next to having my contacts fucking wiped out for no reason.
Why do they do it that way?
Because they're cunts.
I don't know why. Seriously, what's the there's got to be a reason, though.
I thought that was it.
Some kind of reasoning.
I don't know why they do it. They don't have to. I know they don't have to.
No.
You don't think Apple could sit there and go, well, we can't figure out how to get pictures on text.
Yeah.
We can't do it.
I love my BlackBerry, and I do have AT&T, and I have no problems.
But you can get photos on that, can't you?
Yes.
Of course you can.
Of course.
Why wouldn't you be able to?
Of course you can, and full screen and everything.
But
problem.
This one, you use your finger to scroll. Oh, I'm scrolling.
Do the slow one again. No, the fast one that goes all the way to slow. Yeah.
Wrong button, start over. Fucking I really want to firebomb fucking AT&T. They're terrible.
It's all about the BlackBerry. I mean, the Accela train, everybody had a BlackBerry.
Of course,
except
they all
you guys. Except you guys. There were like three iPhones and all the rest first class was BlackBerry.
In the future, the iPhone will blow away
hell
anything.
Hell fucking no, BlackBerry.
You can't search on it. You can't copy and paste.
In
you can't
the
get photos.
Future.
How about they have the first version?
What do you mean you can't copy and paste?
There's no copy and pasting.
What are you talking about?
Like, if I want to copy.
That's all I do.
Well, you can't copy and paste here.
No.
No, why would you be able to? That would be fun and convenient. Why would you need that? I'm going to wear a black turtleneck like Mummenschanz and give a douchey thing. And everybody will ooh and ah.
Ooh.
Finger scroll for numbers. Oh. Can't even take a picture of my fucking dick and send it to a miner.
And you mean coal miner, of course.
No.
Oh.
I know. I'm kidding. I don't know any miners with
Florida
cell phones.
Steve loves scrolling Jimmy. I can't even keep track of all the characters Jimmy does at
There's
this point.
There's a million of them. I fucking scroll. I do
Wait,
it all.
You really can't copy and paste?
No. No.
That's crazy.
Maybe the first, when they first came out with, what was the first options you had? 4 gig and 8 gig?
Yeah.
Whoever has a 4 gig iPhone, put your neck on the train tracks and make a call until your fucking life is ended. Why would you? I'm only going to need 4 gigs.
So it's pretty obvious they weren't ready to put this to market.
They didn't give a fuck.
Right.
They were sticking it up people's asses.
They weren't ready. They should have waited. Why do you think they rushed this? Because they knew
so they can get you to buy a new one.
Because they knew everyone else was working on something too, maybe?
Because they wanted you to come out, and they wanted to show people. Is that Ed McMahon? What the fuck is he doing?
What is Ed McMahon faces foreclosure.
Oh, hilarious. Good.
What the f...
That's great.
Star's money search.
Star is in discussions with his lender trying to work it out. More than 156,000 families have lost their homes to
poor old bastard.
Ed McMahon is facing foreclosure.
All that Carson money, he just probably fucking lost it all.
That young wife of his probably bought like clit hats and all this other shit.
Clit hats.
Gold clit hats.
Well, you gotta buy the clit hat.
You do, but not out of solid gold.
Sure.
Allegedly, she would wear a gold clit hat that weighed like 9 pounds. 9 pounds of gold on your clit is just silly.
So on the iPhone, you can't blind CC, or can you?
No, you can't do
blind CC.
I don't know. I don't have email on this.
You can't copy paste blind CC.
CC copy paste.
So you
no.
can't be angry typing guy on the iPhone.
Well, you can't do much on the iPhone other than look at it and look at your pictures you take because no, I don't have the email function because I know it just keeps sending. And then AT&T, because they are rapists, will fucking douche you for a $1,500 phone bill because it keeps getting sent. Even when you can't shut that feature off.
Data transfer.
Yeah,
how much
fucking
data?
Scumbags. No, no slow clap. Slow scroll.
Our guest is here. Who's our guest?
Yeah.
Who's he?
You know who he is.
Now my phone
silly.
Won't turn on.
What, Jimmy?
Now my iPhone won't turn on.
So let's get Sean William Scott in here, man. We had a great time with him last time he was on the
Why
show.
Why won't my iPhone turn on?
How you doing, man?
Sean William Scott, what's up, bro?
How you been?
Good.
I just heard a story. I can't repeat it. But...
Why not? Yeah,
Why?
I think I got one of these, by the way.
It's a BlackBerry.
Do you have one of these?
Fuck, it's the only way to roll, bro.
Fucking things. I don't know. The thing is, it's so hard to fucking focus on anything. It's always buzzing in your dick.
Meh. Meh. Yep.
So I don't know. I think it's actually been a bad thing.
Well, Kenny's a creep because if you have a BlackBerry, you get probably 800 emails a day. And Kenny decided to put some kind of like alert message for every email that comes in. And that's what I had to deal with on the ride back to New York. Every time one of you idiots sent him an email, bing, oh, I got an email. Then he reads it, puts it back in his pocket, bing, oh, I got another email. Yes.
GH, it's not only emails, it's for text messaging and BlackBerry instant messaging.
Which Kenny,
what's fucking the alert? What is that?
Kenny turned me on to BlackBerry instant messaging. It's like having a little chat, like you're in a little chat room pretty much.
Me and GH, I am each other.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Another way he can keep in touch with you.
You can make fun of him.
Yeah, feel free.
He doesn't even know if you're making fun of him.
What are you doing now, GH?
Huh?
Is that what he texts?
Yeah.
What are you doing now,
GH?
Well, all right, if you need to know.
Everything all right, GH?
All right, hold on.
How's it going, GH?
I will go to our last conversation.
Something tells me you don't get a lot of LOLs out of Kenny.
No. Well, here's our last conversation.
All right.
I actually was stupid enough to start it. I write, did you call me? Everything okay? He writes, no, I did not call you. Everything is good. How about you?
This is just useless communication.
I wrote, good, at dinner with Weeze. He writes, enjoy and give him my regards. I can't wait to meet the person who molded your radio greatness. Why do I have this on?
That never would have been, like, no one would have taken the time to call someone on a regular phone years ago before any of this shit came out. That conversation never would have taken place.
Of course not.
You'd have had to sit there with a paper and pen and write a letter to somebody.
And that's the type of stuff you're like, ah, it's not worth the energy.
Oh, God.
So you got the BlackBerry, Sean?
Yeah. I'm not sure it's a good idea.
I've got to have something.
This is good. I had like the old phone, the old flip-up phone, and then I tossed my nephew into a pool. He's like 8, but he likes the water. But I didn't do it hard enough. He kind of landed awkward, and I thought he broke his leg.
Yeah.
So I waited a little bit to see if he was going to come out of the water, and he didn't. So then I jumped in after him, and he was fucking around. He actually was fine. But then I had my old shit phone that, you know, but I lost all the numbers.
Oh, that stinks.
Yeah, that does.
I know, some good ones on there.
Well,
I'm not a good backer-upper. I don't back up my phone. Like, I'm supposed to, you know, you're supposed to dock it and back it up, all your phone numbers, and I just hear horror stories. Like, yeah, all my numbers got wiped out, but yeah, I got it backed up on my computer. I think the first 3 numbers I put in this are backed up, so if I link it up, it's just going to put 3 numbers on this. I have to back it up because I know it's going to fail.
Wait, you back it up? It won't put 3 numbers on there. What do you mean?
I don't know. I'm afraid.
What you do is, you're panicking that the one that has no numbers is going to wipe it out?
Yes!
I understand. Every queer feels that way. What you have to do is you start off, you go to your fucking iTunes and you set it to sync both ways. It will sync with... It'll that means that this will go with this and this will go with that. No, you don't have one be the master.
I hate when it says, "Do you? If you hit yes, it will wipe out all your tunes that you have on iTunes and replace them with one song."
Yeah,
you know, I had to get the bill for the last 3 months to get my numbers, but it doesn't have the names. So I'm fucking guessing. Like, I'm like, is that Alexis's number?
Yo, who is
Alexis? I'm like, I think it's Alexis. So then I. Like an ass. I got a little drunk, and so I'm like, oh, I'm fucking. I'm just going to give a shot. I'm like, hey, Alexis, what's going on? It's Sean. Like, it's Alexis, it's Amanda. I'm like, fuck. Wrong. I'm screwed. I lost so many numbers.
Dude, you got to do it like this. Hey, you.
Yeah. Hey, you.
Like, hey, you.
How you been, you?
What are you doing?
Yeah. Oh, that's great. I'm thinking of buying you something monogrammed. Any suggestions on letters?
No, you say, like, I can't believe it. It's been a little while since I've seen you. What the hell? How long's it been? And when I tell you 2 weeks, you narrow it down. Yeah. Play 50 questions.
And then you go, oh, my God, I thought it was longer.
To just cover up your spot.
Yeah.
How's your mom? Fuck, dead.
That's
shit.
Right. I forgot I took her to the lake. That was her first date. She blew me behind the fucking casket.
Because she was in mourning.
Oh, fuck. I told her mother would have wanted this.
Mother.
Like, I have a BlackBerry Mini. Now I'm going to say it. And I'm going to have to sell it because I want to get the good BlackBerry as a backup.
Oh, this is the latest one.
But fucking Verizon is a scumbag rapist, too. They're charging me like $250 a month, and I never use it to make calls.
What do you use it for?
I don't know. It just sits there.
You just have a phone sitting there that you don't use.
For emergencies, because the speakerphone is great. The speakerphone on this is shite.
Why the fuck do we have these things other than for a camera? Because really, we don't need to look at our emails right away. I mean,
we do. Get them at home.
You guys do, yeah.
Yeah, it passes the time.
I get them at home, but it's true. It's more of a pass the time thing while you're sitting on the bowl or something.
Or
it's like, oh, I'll check my emails. Fuck.
We had to take a train from New York to Boston, so it was perfect. To just, yeah, you're bored. All right, let's see what's going on.
So wait, you actually have the phone in your hand while you're shitting, and then you put it up to your mouth?
Well, no, I
sanitizing?
As you're shitting, I wouldn't wipe and then pick up the phone.
Okay.
So you're shitting, looking at the phone, doing what you got to do, and then drop it back in the pocket, and you know,
and then wipe,
and then watch when you pull your pants up that you didn't have in the pocket fucked up and have it tumble into the toilet,
and then you wipe your anus muscle.
Yes, then you cleanse the sphincter.
Right.
My fucking phone won't turn on, and it's fully charged.
Oh shit!
Oh,
that thing is going against the wall.
I can't. I have messages on here, text messages. But just so you know, that the fucking people at Apple have fucking robbed you with this fucking piece of shit.
Wow.
My third fucking iPhone.
It's your third one?
My third one.
I'm on my first one, and I love it, Jim.
Yeah, I love the first one, too. And the second one. And this one. What fucking assholes. Get to the Mac Genius.
Take it to the Mac store. They have Mac Geniuses. Yeah. You're right.
They are geniuses.
They'll help you out.
Exactly. They will have fucking Blackberries. They are geniuses.
Jimmy, are you all right?
I can't tell you how angry I am.
He's
my friend's
so
actually
disgusted.
Had the same problem. He's like, he's got three iPhones. He's like, this thing's fucking scary.
It wiped out my contacts recently. It's just, I want to sit down the Apple CEO and talk to him like none of the fucking pussies that work for him will talk to him. And go, it fucking stinks.
That's why they don't let people do that. That's
probably
why they
not.
Only let the yes men in.
That's true. No, who wants to hear that? Especially that tone.
Yeah.
I'm not helping.
That, okay, send Jim Norton right in. What do you have to say to him? Look, you.
Fucking sucks a dick, dude. All right, Jim. We'll get back to you.
Right, we'll go back to the lab with this.